you guys like pizza? I know I do. I love pizza. I'm Italian. I'm disappointed that since I moved out here to the West Coast, there is not a real authentic East Coast Italian style pizza out here. Would you like to have a pizza party with me?
Mamma mia, make it a pizza pie. Pizza pie, Felipe, pizza pie.
Turn on the ovens.
Mozzarella and delicious. Take the dollars and roll it out of your toss in the air. Pizza pie, make it a pizza pie. Pizza pie, Felipe, pizza pie. Pizza pie, delicious pizza pie. Pizza pie, pizza pie.
Turn on the ovens.
Salvagno cheese, Salvagno greasy shit, crazy meat, weird sauce. The sauce has these big chunks of tomato that are very well seasoned that are really good.
Turn on the ovens and burn all the pizzas.
Mamma mia, make it a pizza pie. Pizza pie, Felipe, pizza pie.
Turn on the ovens.
Mozzarella and delicious. Take it a dollar and roll it out of your toss in the air. Pizza pie, make it a pizza pie.
Greasy shit.
Pizza pie, Felipe. Pizza pie.
Weird sauce.
Pizza pie, delicious pizza pie. Pizza pie, pizza pie, mamma mia, make it a pizza pie, pizza pie, Felipe, pizza pie,
turn on the ovens,
mozzarella, and delicious, take the dollars and roll it out of your toss in the air, pizza pie, make it a pizza pie,
greasy shit,
pizza pie, Felipe, pizza pie,
cheese,
pizza pie, delicious pizza pie,
weird sauce,
pizza pie,
crazy meat,
pizza pie,
turn on the ovens.
Now on to the more exotic seasonings. These seasonings are catered more towards Italians. If you're not Italian, you don't like these kind of seasonings, you don't have to use them, but I'm Italian and I love
it. People are basically like exploding in the stream chat. People who, oh, they pretend like they support me, they pretend like they're positive, and they're not, they're shitheads. They sit here and they sneak this and they say underhanded things. They try to literally bring up either detractor memes or literal drama shit every day. They do it on purpose so that they can try to derail the shit that I'm doing on my streams, you know? And it just gets to the point where it's so frustrating. I just want to have fun, man. I really just want to fucking have fun. That's it. That's all I want to have to do is have fun with you guys.
Fun, 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 fun. Way more fun. Fun, 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 fun.
I just want to have
fun, 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 fun. Way more fun. Fun, 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 fun.
I just want to have no taxes, bills to pay. Nice chill stream today. You're having a fun and interactive time with me and you're finding entertainment, positivity, and value in it. Then the support should just come naturally. Okay? I just want to have
fun, 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 fun. Way more fun, 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 fun.
I just want to have
fun, 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 fun. Way more fun, 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 fun.
Here's the bottom line, and I'm tired of it now. No more excuses, all right? Because the bottom line is people are like, Phil's not engaged in his commentary, and Phil's commentary is boring, and that's why people don't want to watch the playthroughs of the streams. Bullshit. I'm loving this game. I'm voice acting. I'm engaged. I'm commentating on everything that's going on actively. Bullshit. I call massive bullshit on any idiot who says that about either the Watch Dogs 2, which I've been playing recently and really liking, or Pokemon. It's bullshit. I call complete and utter bullshit on anyone who's saying that I'm not engaged and I sound like I'm bored. I'm not. So I've had enough excuses. It just seems to me like people are fucking lazy and don't want to come out to the streams. I don't even know what else to say, you know?
Tasty banana, put it in your mouth and squeeze. Put it in your mouth and squeeze. Tasty banana, tasty banana, put it in your mouth and squeeze. Put it in your mouth and squeeze.
Just put it in your mouth.
Tasty banana.
off and squeeze. Taste the banana. I want banana, taste the banana. Put it in my mouth and squeeze. Aussie banana, taste the banana. Put it in your mouth and squeeze. Put it in your mouth and squeeze. Aussie banana, taste the banana. Put it in your mouth and squeeze. Put it in your mouth and squeeze.
I actually don't know what the song sounds like. I have no idea.
That being said.
Hello. This is Phil Burnell. All right. And just wanted to tell you that I love the podcast. That being said, big ups. That being said, which vest is podcast best? Being set. Relaxing, chill, interactive, fun. Tap being set. Which vest is podcast best? Tap being set. Relaxing, chill, interactive, fun. ALT. Insider. The legend. Fantastic Mr. Sam. The dentist. Sneak to the dead. Psychological style host. Get well soon, man. Me your cat. Artistic style host. Tap being set. Which vest is podcast best? Tap being set. Which vest is podcast best?
If there is ever meaningful content, it's being produced right here on That Being Said.
Lemtex, you have to join. There we go. All right, my friends, we are here and it is time. What a time to be alive. What a time to be in this world, we crazy world we're in. It is time for Ka-Ching of the Ring 2024. And I promise we have all this broken all the stops. What is it? What's the word? Taken out all the stops.
Pulled out.
Yes. I pulled out and also pulled out all the stops. This is going to be extremely hype. We got Lemtex, the Ka-Ching of the Ring of 2023. Real quick, Lemtex, how has your life changed since you won? Just be honest.
Well, I took the $50 and I DoorDash some Burger King. I got a chicken sandwich. It wasn't the King of the Ring, and I'll tell you what. The burger on the screen looks a lot better than the one I had. So,
nice.
Phil for that.
Big ups.
Don't know what you got till it's gone, I guess.
All right. So, Lemtex is obviously our guest judge today. Obviously, you can see Sam is not here. That's a very unfortunate, but he couldn't make it. It sucks. That's what it is. It just sucks, but it couldn't happen. So, we're going to move together positively and try to have some fun. With that being said, Meerkat, business style announcements. That's your job. Come on, hit us with it.
Hell yeah, brother. Well, now, guys. This is our biggest event of the year. It's basically our WrestleMania. It's the first event we've ever had twice. But I will go into a brief explanation of the rules and the contest itself. We have about like 38 people submitted their songs. It's a maximum at 90 seconds long. They're going to be graded from each of us from 1 to 6 stars. And chat is also going to grade them 1 to 6 stars as well. Except that chat scores count 5 times our scores. So chat now has more power than ever before. So make sure to click on that poll when it shows up and vote for, you know, the song that's on screen. The maximum score is 48. 10 people are going to make it to the final, where I guess they can decide if they want to have a new song or the same old song. And the winner gets, listen to this. What do you not get? You get a $50 in positivity. You get a choice for a game from provided to us by, shout out to Regis Philgen, who has had such success with Who Wants to Be a Fillionaire that they are now a fillionaire themselves and are contributing to the prizes. So you get to pick one of the games that is offered, and also you get a free piece of merch of your choosing from the shop, and that's about it. And then you get to flex about it like Lemtex does.
Obviously. Dude. I mean, Lemtex is getting laid like every day because he's kicking the ring. Am I right about that?
I can't even believe it, man.
That's what I thought. So, I mean, this is awesome. Before we get to this, I do want to say a lot of people got to thank. Big ups to Snood. Last year, a lot of songs. We weren't sure what the lyrics were exactly. And this year, 38 fucking songs. They all have lyric videos. So you will know what everyone said in all of them. And that's thanks to Snood. So big ups to Snood on that one. Also, big ups to Chew. I am a roller hockey coach. And today, there's a roller hockey game. But I will not be there coaching. Chew will be the coach. So good luck, Chew, on that game. Nice. Hope my kids with their non-declawed kids can win. So that'll be pretty hype. But obviously that also means, my friends, we have no divorce line and we might need it. So we have 38 songs to get to. Lemtex, I hope you don't have a divorce line. Do you have a divorce line, Lemtex?
I'm good. I'm good. I just woke up like 15 minutes ago and checked Twitter for any gaming news and I'm here.
Big ups. All right. Before we get started, Mirka, I think you wanted to say we should say how we're going to judge this thing. Do we want to get to that now, or what kind of style judge
sure,
you want to
yeah.
be? Okay.
I wanted to ask you guys, what are you going to base your judgments on? I'm going to go first.
Yes.
Since last year we saw like incredible amounts of talented people showing up, I think the bar has been raised so much throughout the different competitions we've done. So this year, me personally giving out a 6 stars, it's probably going to be very rare.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to be the Simon Cowell of the group. I'll try and be fair and, of course, judge everything in good faith. And yeah, that's just it for me. What about you guys?
Lemtex, you go next. You're the ka-ching.
So am I to understand it's 1 to 6? Because last year it was like 3 to 6 or 4 to 6, due to some kind of limitation in the
code
or something.
Because the YouTube doesn't let us do that many choices for polls, so we have to limit it to 3, 4, 5, or 6. Yeah. Yes.
So okay. I don't know. I look at a 6 as like something that is gonna stand the test of time, basically. Like a year from now, will it still live on like outside of Cha-King, you know what I mean?
Absolutely. So, okay.
That's what I'm thinking of for a 6.
Okay. And I think so too. I think last year we were a little bit fast and loose, like with our scores. So it's going to be a little bit tougher. And I agree. 6 needs to be, holy shit, I want to hear that again. So that's how I'm going to be doing it. In chat, you can vote however you want. Also, last year we did replays. As you might guess, we cannot do replays this year because we have 38 songs to play and 8 interludes. So we have like 45 videos to play today. So no replays, no matter how good it is. I don't care if it gets perfect scores. We cannot replay it. Rewind the stream. You know what I'm saying?
Really? So, no replays for a perfect?
I mean, I
think a perfect is going to be pretty rare.
All right. Meerkat's changed. He is the commissioner, so he can do this. So Commissioner Meerkat.
Okay, let's see how it goes.
Let's see how it goes. If we don't have one till halfway through and then we get one, maybe we can do it. But
if
you know
the
what I'm
chat
saying?
Threatens a mutiny, I think maybe we'll consider it.
All right, let's fucking go. Before any sporting event happens, as you guys might expect, you do have to do the national anthem. And we also will be doing the national anthem here. Please do whatever you do. And let's play our national anthem here for everyone in attendance today.
Should we stand up?
I don't think so. No, I'm not going through that much
effort. I'm
going
to stand
up. Don't worry.
I'm standing too.
Did you watch the side-scrollers interviewing Phil Burnell? He is the one who wanked on stream and then blamed it on mental health. When the beating off on stream leads to beating your demons, there's a chance to own the meme and raise lots of funds.
Is he down from the rafters and previously the gun show?
1651 to PayPal, where did all the payments go?
He fetches the paper that shows how he spends his dough.
Did you hear the hateful slurs that are said by Dark Side Phil? Joking about the slave trade did not go down with the Kriegler well. The joke is child trafficking. Racism was not the subject. Let's just move on because Adam's completely correct.
Our game is here, D-Way. work real bad.
Detractors of Phil are wrong, but documentaries on Keem are fact. Now Gundam has questions, we need one more DDoS attack.
Did you watch The Interview? More like a grid of DSP. Brought up the fact that Cat had been abused, so he would get PT. When the DT love your wife, you can exploit it for some clout. Adam and Craig were such a small pressing heads to gout.
How's the gout, Phil?
Did you see the post-stream clip? DSP said it's just Thursday. Wearing the headgear of the Nazis, well, that's what the detractors say. On good terms he did depart when everything was said and done. But DSP will fall apart when tomorrow comes.
Think Jean Valjean should have gone to jail for stealing bread or just gotten a warning?
Yeah.
All right, my friends, thanks so much to everybody who took part in that. That was great. That was moving, I'm gonna be honest.
We have a last minute development. Also, okay. It's worth noting that during the interludes, we're gonna be giving shout outs and everything.
Yes. Yep.
But now we have a last minute development. Massive shout out to Mad Max the Seventh, who sent us £100.
Oh my god.
Incredible. And he asked that half of this, or $50, to go to the winner if possible, seeing as we're raising the bar. I cannot agree more. So yes. Now the winner gets $100 and all the other stuff.
Yes. A reminder, we won't find the winner tonight, by the way. Remember how it works.
Yes.
This is round one. We have a finals. We have to find the final day for that. But, you know, and then did we decide if it's top eight or top 10, Meerkat? I forgot to ask you about that.
It's top 10.
Yeah, top 10. Okay,
I think
good.
That's fair. Yeah.
So top 10.
Top
and then,
10 highest ratings.
Yes. And then you got to write another song and we'll get to the finals. And that'll be hype whenever that is. So let's get to it. Enough nonsense. Big ups, everybody, for the massive contributions here. Thanks, everybody. We will shout them out at the break times. But let's get to our first competitor, Meerkat. Who is that?
The first competitor is called Beg182 with the song The Clown Show.
All right. You heard it. Big 182 with The Clown Show. Let's fucking go.
Staying in his office every single weekend. Playing games, watching bits, having no friends. Saving up for the hardcore gaming season. You'll always find shitty day one gameplay here. Every day it's always yelling and complaining. Toxic moments makes us constant entertaining. He'll tell you that he's no longer that guy. It's another one of many different lies. So let's tune in and experience the clown show. Speak the truth and he'll tell you that he doesn't know. In his mind, he believes that he's a gaming pro. Everything's better when he gets mad. No tips come in which makes him sad. Let's tune in and experience the clown show. He hangs the same old shit up on his walls. He'll hang them till they fall. Because it saves him money. Watch him get many different member bombs. Hear him call Cat his mom. And of course there's Jasper. So let's tune in and experience the clown show. Speak the truth and he'll tell you that he doesn't know. In his mind he believes that he's a gaming pro. Everything's better when he gets mad. No tips come in which makes him sad. Let's tune in and experience the clown show.
Fuck! God damn it! All right, we did say we have to be more strict with our scores now. Holy fuck! Strong start. Beg 182, of course, was in the competition last time, raising the bar. Oh fuck, man! All right, I'm not going first. Ka-ching of the ring, you go first, please. Ka-ching.
Oh, that's bullshit. So it is. I'm doing 1-6, right? That's
1-6. Scale. Yes.
Yep.
I can show you
I think I'll go five
from Lemtex.
Thought about four. See, a four, I think, is still a good score.
Yes. Just, better than average.
I don't want to see that now. I feel like I'm being a little too nice with a five, but.
Uh-oh, you could get
it. Nah, I'm going four. Fuck it. I'm going four.
All right. That's
four is still above average, and I think that's exactly what this song was. Yeah. It's pretty funny. I do like the production on the vocals is very Blink-182-ish.
Yes.
Didn't knock me dead with the jokes, but still everything flowed pretty well. So I'm going four just to, you know, start us out.
Okay. I'll go next. I would say a five. I think the mixing on that was just beautiful, well produced. I like Lemtek said, it wasn't the funniest of all time, but the quality overall was there. That's a five for me. Meerkat, go ahead.
Yeah, I'm basically on the same page as both of you guys. I feel somewhere definitely a strong four, but I'm going to give it a five, a light five.
Okay.
And like you guys said, the mixing on the vocals, I found out today, mixing vocals sometimes is a pain in the ass, and you got to appreciate it when you see it.
Yes.
I'm going to give this a five.
There we go. And it looks like chat is
seems
also, yep.
Settled on a five as well. So
a four.
That's going to be it for the first ever entry.
Big ups. Big 182 in the house. Who is next, Sir Cat?
Next up, we have Bob Starsky with Fleminem.
You know
without
Bob Starsky.
Me.
Here we go. Bob Starsky in the house.
We're
going to
see a lot of familiar names today.
Yep.
A lot of them.
Yep.
And also, while I was making the spreadsheet, I also saw a lot of new names. So I'm very excited to see the new entries and the new contributors.
Mm-hmm. That's what I'm most excited for. I mean, so many people, the first time we heard a song from them was fucking Last Ka-Ching. And then they've been making songs since then, like Bob Starsky, like Lemtex. So let's get to it. Bob Starsky in the house with Fleminem.
Gerish Ape, real name, no gimmicks.
New Brazy Mambo's 1195, 1195, 1195.
1195? You can't afford 1195? What's your problem?
Officer Sanders called me a pedophile, me a pedophile, me a pedophile.
Now that I know that she's into pedophilia, I will mark that.
Oh, now you said it.
Look who's back again. Brazy is back.
Now, guys, here's the thing.
I don't have any sponsors, cause nobody wants to see me show no more, so I'll just back up a phone quick.
You need that money.
When you get the king, this is what I'll get. I had you wanna see mix when they saw it. It's a pen, he's gonna cam my pants. Looking with the bill, we should get bills at the hospital by the doctor while I'm on your food complaining. And I'm rocking at the soup, but I am not obtaining.
Swag!
You waited this long to stop the railing, cause I'm back from my household being operated.
I'm a mature adult.
Worry how my health's curated. It's the guy whose disc can be the herniated. The FGC has left me be Chef Boyardee, fuck you like me. Really shut me down on Twitch TV. No 50 bit bitches without me. So, back to the tips, that's now quick.
Fuck this.
Smacking my lips, gonna race quick. Get
bullshit.
Ready, that's gonna try and upsell me. I just learned a brand new fact.
Thank you, Derek.
Was raffle bags that were not cheap. So everybody, keep crowdfunding. Like me sandwiches, I will not eat. And I make more money than LTG. Said fuck that Comcast employee. Ryan is a slayer, OIC. Former alcoholic, down shut on stream. You don't feel meaningful without me.
Oh god. Oh my god. Oh my god.
He's gonna go first.
I'll go first again.
Oh, yes, please.
I will say six because, first of all, you got the video, right?
Yes.
Just fucking rapid fire jokes out of nowhere. There's not necessarily a theme, so it kind of, you know, they catch you off guard.
Yes.
Bangers after bangers. I love the Justin Wong
oh
and Matt with the kids on the screen.
That was
I didn't
so
see what
awesome.
Was Phil? Did Phil have like Jasper or something?
You know,
I don't know.
He was holding food.
Oh. Yeah, all right, six.
Dude, and you know, I am make no apologies about my Bob Starsky fandom. Like Lemtek said, he hits my sense of humor perfectly with the randomness when you don't expect it. He just hits you with the references. I didn't go in. I was going to be strict on Bob. You know? I don't want to be accused of going fake favorites.
I think this is his best work.
But
so
this
far.
Was his best work of all time. That's a six for me every day. Every day of the fucking week. That's a six. And I make no apologies about it. Bob Starsky is incredible. Meerkat, go ahead.
Look, the only minus I have against this is the production, but I'm not going to take away any points because, like, everything else was just so fucking good. It was so funny. Punchlines, the jokes, the actual editing in the video is just, I was holding on to, like, every bar because it was just, it was so engaging. And also captured the spirit of Eminem, because when you cover a song, you need to capture the original spirit of the artist that made it. And this did it, man. I got to give this a 6. So we got a perfect score from the panel.
And, so you know what that means, douchebag, commissioner?
Oh, no.
What does that mean?
Replay, you were saying.
Well, all right. What does Chad think? Yeah, so Chad gave it a 6, too, with a 67%. So I think they're feeling like a replay.
All right. We got our first replay. We'll be here till midnight, boys. Let's fucking go. Bob Starsky, instant replay. Let's go.
Real name, no gimmicks.
New Brazy Mambo's 1195, 1195, 1195.
1195? You can't afford 1195? What's your problem?
Officer Sanders called me a pedophile. Me a pedophile. Me a pedophile.
A poster of Fat Cat.
Yep.
The movie posters were all over it.
Oh, now you said it.
Back again. Dave is back.
Now, guys, here's the thing.
Easter eggs all over the place.
Nobody wants to see me show no more, so I'll just make up a phone quick.
Need that money.
When you get the king, this is what I'll get.
The guy right there.
I just want to see mix when they saw it. It's a plan, and he's gonna encamp my plans. Looking with the bill, we should get bills at the hospital by the doctor while I munch your food complaining. And I'm rocking at the support I am not obtaining. He waited this long to stop the raid, because I'm back from a household being operated. Don't worry how my health's curated. It's the guy whose disc can be the herniated. The FGC has left me.
Is it funnel cake? What the fuck?
That's the tips. That's now quick.
Fuck this.
Smack my lips. Gonna race quick. Get bullshit. Ready. That's gonna try and upsell me. I just learned a brand new fact. Thank you, Derek. Was wrong for bags that were not cheap. So everybody, keep crowdfunding like my sandwiches. I will not eat and I make more money than LTG. Said fuck that Comcast employee. Ryan is a slayer. OIC. Former alcoholic. Down shut on stream. Feel meaningful without
me. Amazing.
There's so many references and so much lore in this one. It's just like it's packed to the brim with stuff. And not just the song, the video too. It's great.
Easter eggs all over the place. I saw more the second time around. The guy was in there in one of the shots in the background. There was all the movie posters that Barrett Wells has ever done was in there. Amazing. All right, Meerkat, we do have to move on.
All right.
Yep, go ahead.
Next up, we have Sir Boris Rue with the song Tips All Around Me.
Tips All Around Me. Boris Rue, I believe this is a new competitor, new entrant into the Ka-Ching of the Ring.
Hell yeah, brother. That works for me.
Boris Rue, let's fucking go.
Feel it in my pockets, I feel it in my tips. I need more Kim Kat beside me in everything I do. It's written in the news, Beast Merchant got you, eat it. If these chill vibes are in you, come on and let money go.
Money go.
No, I love those tips, I always will. It's always in the back of my head, way that I feel. Cause on the SP game you can super however you like and thanks. Super chat, super stickers, membership, gift to membership, and tips.
All right, that was the ending. All right, Meerkat, you go first this time. Let's give Lemtex a break. Come on.
Oh man, I'm really split because it feels like if DSP was gonna make a song, this is what it would sound like, because it's like offbeat and he's stumbling, and he got the best part was the mom cat moment when he just like forgot what he was talking about. But I'm feeling a 4, I think.
Okay.
In my heart.
Okay, we're gonna go with 4. I was gonna say, like, was it the meme play to pretend you're kind of drunk, or was he actually drunk? I kind of wish I could ask him. Like, was that a play to add to the funniness, or was it, you know, I don't know.
That's what I'm thinking as well. Yeah.
Was it a meme? I'll say it's a. I'm gonna give a 3. There wasn't any like knock your socks off joke there. I'd say 3 from me. Lemtex, what about you?
I think on a technical level, it's a 3, but I think just the weirdness of it, like I picture this like a drunk guy like stumbling into a mall karaoke place and be like, hey, I put this CD in, I got a song to sing, and he just like fucking does it one shot, and the hard cut at the end made me laugh. So I'm gonna go 4 for this one.
All right, we got 3, 4, 4 for us. What has chat got?
Chat is it's split between a 3 and a 4.
All right, chat.
It's 1% difference, so I guess we can stall for a second or
definitely
two.
Definitely stall.
Just to see how that's going to work. And, well, now we got a 3% difference, so let's go to the higher one, and it's a 4.
4. I agree. Mimic Texture, a 4 because it had heart. I should have done a 4 for that. It did have heart. I'll definitely say that. It did have heart. Anyways, next competitor, please. Meerkat.
Next up, brother, we have Brad Burnian, brother, with Brad Smash Burnian. Gout.
All right.
Lol Cow.
Ooh, okay. Maybe we know where this is going. All right, Brad Burnian in the house. Let's go.
Somebody once told me they love DSP's content. I guess that's why they call them a dent. Phil just took a massive fail working on his dumb thumbnails and taking care of his son Hauntance. Still, 15 years as a content creator, buried in his hair is a giant fucking crater. Didn't make sense to wash until the fans told me to, so I guess I will. Keep on streaming, I need money, so what's so wrong with begging? You won't tip if I don't ask.
Money, I really do.
They membership at the ass. Hey now, you're a lol cow on level 1, greedy. Hey now, you're a failure, you're a joke, Phil, piggy.
Your whole legacy shame.
Only the detractors keep you relevant. In the snort fort, everything keeps breaking. Phil never gave his bird, always keeps taking. Won't go to get blood work, but Jasper puts money in champions faster and faster. The toxicity is always so high. Derek's in the chat, so you better say bye. For burps and snorts, probably farts. By the way, my fan should have gotten 6 stars.
Oh.
Hey now, thanks for listening. Gotta change the lyrics. Hey now, gotta finish in 90 seconds.
Oh my god, the last minute 5 out of nowhere.
What I brought into this? Jesus. Wow. What the fuck was that?
God damn it.
Out of nowhere. Some random super out of nowhere. Holy shit. All right. Well, I'll go first on this one. Yeah. No, I think I was going to say 3, but then they put a lot of effort into this video to make it funnier. Like, the video made it a 4, probably. When I would have said 3 if it was just audio, video was funny. I'll say 4. All right. Meerkat, what about you?
Oh, man. I'm thinking a 3 on this one because the song technically wasn't the greatest. I do love, though. That's why I'm split between a 3 and a 4. Mm-hmm. I do love the meta song in the end, where it's just like talking about how he needs to cut it to like 90 seconds.
Yeah.
And then you just get a random diss out of nowhere.
Yeah. That was hype.
Oh, yeah.
All right, Lemtex, Sir Kaching.
Yeah, I'm kind of with Meerkat on this one. It feels like he's like halfway through and he's just like, fuck it, go for the moonshot. Like, fuck ALT score, try to score points with everybody else. But still, with the production issues, I think I'm going with a 3.
All right. Chat, it is in your hands now. Looks like 4 for chat, though.
It's split, it looks pretty solid.
All right.
Well, their vote counts Much more than ours. Yes. So, yeah. Good job, you guys.
Helps chat. All right, Sir Cat, who is next on the docket?
All right, brother, let me tell you something. Next up. Oh, man, next up is Brooke Baroque with the song Pig Miser.
All right.
I assume that's how it's pronounced.
First time competitor here, Brooke Baroque. Let's go.
I, Mr. Greed Christmas, I am the guy. I, Mr. Gowd Crystal, I, Mr. Decade of Lies. Trolls call me Pig Miser, whatever I touch breaks and bugs in my clutch. I'm too much. John Rambo, I want you so fucking bad. Oh.
Oh, God.
He's Mr. King of the
No.
He cranks his hog.
That's correct.
He's Mr. Hulk Hogan. He's Mr. Sinus's.
Why am I toxic?
Dents call me Pig Miser. Whatever I touch breaks and bugs in my clutch. I'm too much. I never wanna know a day that's under 100 and tips. I'd rather hire Derek to de-herniate my disc.
Etcetera.
He's known as the Pig Roach. He has three fans.
Please tip me.
He wants all your money. He'll lean in manual man.
Dents call me Pig Miser. Whatever I touch breaks and bugs in my clutch. I'm too much burger.
There we go. Brooke Baroque in the house with a very, very unique song there. Meerkat, you're first this time.
All right, brother. Now, first of all, I am not simping, but okay. I do think the video had a lot of effort put into it, and the song on a technical level sounded nice. I enjoyed it. I didn't think it was losing my mind funny, but I appreciate the humor, the lyrics, the performance.
Yes.
So I think I'm going to give it a 5.
Okay.
Just feel positive.
I was also going to preface this with I'm not simping, but I appreciate the randomness of the video. I love my random shit, and that was full of random shit. And that flicking off of the hamsters, that earned you a star right the fuck there, because that was a good joke. I'm going to say 4, though. I will say 4 on that one. Overall, great, though, and I want to watch it again to see all the other shit you did that I missed, but that's a 4 for me. Lemtex.
First of all, I just want to make it clear I am simping.
Okay, good. Thank you. You're allowed. You're the king.
I'm kind of with you guys. It's, you know, it takes a lot of guts to do like a video like that.
And, uh-huh.
I think what would have pushed it to a 6 for me was if she body slammed one of the gerbils or whatever.
Oh,
or whatever
Phil does. You wanted her to actually kill one. Okay.
Yeah, as it is right now, I'll give it a 5.
Yes, Brooke, you should have taken a hamster and put it down the garbage disposal. That would have got you a 6. Next time.
Yep. And chat has locked into a 5. So there we go. We have everything settled.
Big ups.
Next up, brother, we have Cyborg Crab. With Elton Beggs, Sequestering Fever.
All right.
This one sounds very
Elton
exotic.
Elton Beggs. Gotta love it. Elton Beggs. Come on, dude. Come in. Get in here. Elton Beggs.
Well, howdy, that being said. Well, all I know is what I've been told. Seattle air is better than snow. I ain't sold shit and I don't pay tax. Got 13 cards. I might just max sequestering fever. Ain't never got me down. Sequestering fever. Ain't got no one around. With a credit card in my hand, I'm going out to stake some Washington land. Sequestering fever. Ain't never got me down.
Well, I told my parents this is good for me. No income tax, no condo fees. I said the state, and Linda began to weep. But didn't I say I'd call once a week? Next on the list was Panda Lee. Abandon your friends and live with me. Quit your job, I'll pay the lot. No need for sex, just cook me slop. Sequestering fever ain't never got me down. Sequestering fever ain't got no one around. Proposing couldn't make her stay autistic, so made on the way. Sequestering fever ain't never got me down. Well, I found me a condo. Where do I sign? Rent the other? Dude, I have no time. It's away from Seattle to avoid the crime. With walls so high, urbans just can't climb. Only leave about once a week. And I'm telling you, Steve, that shit ain't bleak. Finally, time to sit and stream on Twitch, where I'll stay for a decade like a stupid bitch.
Wow.
Yeehaw. Friends, who needs them?
Woo, mama. Another hype entry here. So many awesome ones so far. I guess it's Lemtex. Your turn to go first this time.
Let's see. I think I'm going to go with a 4.
All right. Because, any explanation? Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, see, now I'm getting used to the video aspect of it, and this one was just kind of, you know, just a lyric video, which is fine. But yeah, I don't know. Maybe it's just not my thing, the old country style.
All right.
Country style burger style sandwich style. I don't know. Yeah, 4.
All right. The king has spoken. That's a 4. I would say 5. The jokes were strong enough in there. The jokes are strong enough to get me to a 5. You know, and that's just how it's got to be. I think it's the jokes are strong. There's two or three like really good jokes in there. Walls so high the urbans can't climb. That was a great one. That's a 5 for me every day. Go ahead, Meerkat.
yeah, some really good jokes in there. The writing itself felt very natural and it was fun. I was along for the ride, you know. Every line had something in it that I thought was really clever. So I'm going to give this a 5. I enjoyed it very much.
Here we go. Like chat agrees with me and Meerkat.
Yep. There we go. Well, we locked it in at a 5 from chat. And the next song, ladies and gentlemen, is an interlude.
Oh, interlude time.
Which is... it's ALT's Denthead Party.
Ah. Oh, my God. So. We forgot to play the fucking intro.
Oh, no. You
oh
can play it now.
Oh, my God. Oh, fucking douchebags. All right. Let's do the intro now. The intro All video right. I fucking made. Spent fucking so much time on it. I'm going to fucking forget it. Dude, I've been awake too much the last 2 days. I took off work yesterday and today to get shit ready for this, and I have slept like 4 hours in the last 2 days, so feeling good. All right, let's get to it. Intro. Let's pretend the intro, we're going to do the intro now, so let's get hype, all right? Get hype now. All right. Here's the intro. Start the show. Let's go.
The Chicken Chicken Sandwich. They have a new chicken sandwich at Burger King. And they have two varieties.
Three,
they have a regular,
two,
which is like lettuce, tomato,
one,
onion, and mayo. And then they have one that's the spicy one. There's that spicy sauce and some other kind of sauce on it. Okay. I pull my hand out of the bag. My hand, all right, is completely covered in sauce. So what they did, they completely soaked the sandwich in sauce. What they do with this chicken sandwich is they wrap it in wrap,
oh God.
And then they put it inside of a foil bag. So I opened the foil bag.
The whole colony of people.
And I was like, what the fuck? Okay, now I'm gonna cough.
And flame it up, heat in my feet. Shouldn't have eaten that fucking shellfish. It was my aunt, she's the one who's to blame. Fucking died without saying a word. Too much red meat, DoorDash all day. Still not my fault, you mouth droolers. Can't lose my streak, need to stay on the grind. I'm a spool, my roommate is my wife. Cherry juice for which I sip as I pull out my phone for some Hogan's.
I should not. Yeah, right in front of people at Burger King.
All right, you ready to start now? Well, we can start the show.
Let's begin.
All right, let's take it from the top.
Yeah. There we go. Gatto the Beggar coming at you. That was the intro video. Now, is it overkill, ALT overkill, if we do the next interlude that we're supposed to do on schedule when we're cat or what?
Yeah, let's do it, and then we can give some shout-outs yes. and move on to the second section.
Well, how about this? Let's do shout-outs now. Let's do shout-outs now, then we'll end the interlude with another song to get us back in the mood. So, Meerkat, could you do some shout-outs there?
All right. I'm going to be saying the names of members that yes. renewed. Big ups Casio Kid, Ajaman, Level 99 Catfish, Tony, Zenicat. Shout out to Battery Exhausted for the one gifted. Shout out to Level 99 Catfish for the five gifted. Threaded Kane, five gifted. Dark Sea to Flow, five gifted. Jessica S, the listener, one gifted. RS Nerd 008 for the five gifted. Twerk to Spec says, give this to the winner. Yep. Has sent us $2 super chat. So we're going to. It's now officially $102.
Big ups.
Shout out Mr. Matt, Andrew R, Dune Messiah, QB113, Wesley H for the five gifted, and Koa Nguyen for the $20. And big ups to LR, who says ALT was 93 when this song came out.
That's not true.
Could have been about any on any song so far.
Not true. Thank you.
It's all right, brother. Let's keep on rolling, baby.
All right.
What time it is.
Interlude time again. This is our next interlude. Then we keep moving. Here we go. Denhead Party. Coming at you. WPIG.
Today, and I am really excited. I'm going to listen to my favorite song.
I've eaten 10 crayons, but no Vesco. Watching DSP beg for a few quarters. We got 100 likes, but no bubble blow.
Shut the fuck up about the fucking bubble.
Watching DSP rage quit Kirby Dark Souls.
I didn't buy Kirby Dark Souls. You should have hit him. You sucked the hell out of him. That should be the end of the fight right here. That should be the end of the fight. Okay, you did.
Waiting for Canadian Kuma to arrive. He's gonna beat his meat until it's not alive. That PDF file will start spamming facts. DSP defends him while he starts to jack.
Who's recommending traitors and stuff?
I have no social life. No one does in here. We were hit by something while we were in the womb. It's a den head party. Phil will make some more. Everybody's drooling. Never gotten laid before. Never had a single friend before. Phil yells at us and then we come. We're den head.
Fun of any stream chatter, Derek or otherwise, you're a fucking loser.
This is great. Thank you, Phil.
There we go. Interlude style done. That was a Denhead Party, everybody. Big ups.
Hell yeah.
All right. Next submission, please. Sir Cat.
Next, we pick it right back up where we left it with Dark Side Drill with the song Pig
Ooh,
Iverson.
Mama. A lot of people were waiting for Dark Side
got
Drill.
Got a hard hitter, man.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Second place last year behind the one and only Lemtex. Let's go. This is Dark Side Drill. Was he actually? I think I'm messing up the lore. Who was second place, Lemtex? Do you remember who you toppled with your king?
I think Dark Side Drill.
Oh, there we go. Was
yeah, it was a 40K.
Yes, there
that
we go.
Was a song.
40 grand for the cup. All right, let's go.
These detractors, whatever.
Been waiting for this one.
They're so butthurt. So butthurt.
I'm begging on you. I'm stretching, oh. Keep tipping, I'ma spend it on boo.
bankruptcy, bankruptcy, oh yeah. Spend my cash, Kevin Nash, WWE. I got me a fade and reusable bags. Criminals took them away and they won't give them back.
Yeah.
I got nobody to call, so I called up my dad.
My dad says, so I'm hard, sorry to hear about all this, but I just want to let you know, I caught a rainbow trout.
This is how I address my channel, yeah. Pick my nose and wipe it on my crotch. Dip me and you get gugats. Go laughs and tequila shots, yeah. But you know I really need the tips. Ooh, 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 ooh. Street Fighter 6. 672. Better watch your lips.
Nobody go tell the editor.
Pig Iverson. When I started begging, I was young. I got a stroked out tongue.
Oh, God.
I need tips like the money match I never won. Go. I'm begging, I'm begging, I'm begging on you. I'm stretching, I'm stretching, I'm stretching on you. Keep tipping, keep tipping. I'ma spend it all on birds. Fuck you, Jasper. I kill T, I kill T.
Well, I will not sign your forehead. Thank you for the cheer.
Oh, God. Oh, man. All right. I'll go first on this one. Man. I think the joke's that hard. You have to say six. That, I mean, a few of those jokes, you can't. It just. I killed T. Fuck you, Jasper. And the video. The video, also a lot of good work in the video. A lot of references in there. I'm saying six on that. Meerkat, you're next.
Yeah, I was split between a 5 and a 6, and then he did like the monkey sounds and started laughing and
yes.
Left it in the song, which I appreciate. And then he did the vocal harmonies, which I always appreciate. And the vocal mixing was on point as always. And he did a song that I know. So I feel like this connected with me. And also it had a Ain't Nobody Gonna Tell Me How to Live reference. So of course.
Ain't nobody gonna tell me how to live.
Yeah, this has got to be a 6 for me.
All right.
It's just, he brought it.
Lemtex, you're next.
I'll say 6. I mean, it's hard not to give a 6 to Dark Side Drill.
Well, we do have to say, it's your score. We should. Hey, it's not
Lifetime
Achievement
Award. No, I'm not saying that.
Okay.
I mean, you know, it's just, you know, it's a 6, but like, it's almost like he's given me too much in the past month, where I'm getting like I want sevens and eights from him now, you know what
ah.
I mean? But it's a 6, and I just want to say the Argentina song, the first time I heard it like a month ago, and the guitar solo came in and it was like Cobra playing guitar or some
yes.
shit. I don't know, I was fucking laughing my ass off of that, but yeah, it's a 6 for me.
There we go.
Well, I don't mean to be a killjoy, but according to the rules, you can only have a 90-second song, and this song is 2 minutes and 9 seconds.
Oh,
so
hold
we
up.
Have a problem here.
Oh no,
we have
oh,
a
no.
problem
yeah,
here. So
minus
we,
points.
Yeah, we can't be fair to everybody else who submitted according to the rules and still
hold on. Because you know. I hold on. Let me check our. Let me make sure. Let me check our correspondences. I'll make sure I didn't say anything. This one. Okay.
All right. I only consider the first 90 seconds, and I'll still give it a 6.
Like, is that a DQ? I can't be a DQ, can it? We're not. It's not the fucking Olympics, is it?
I guess we can hit him with a slight point reduction of like, I don't know, let's say 3 points or 4, something like that. That sounds fair, because otherwise we're being unfair to everybody else.
That's true too.
They,
yes.
they had a yeah, because you know the challenge was to fit it in 90 seconds.
Because I'm just checking. I just want to check the correspondences
well,
here.
The last like 30 seconds just like a redux of the chorus. I don't know. I don't remember.
Yeah, was it? Yeah, that's true too. Was it just doing the chorus again? Like if we're stopping at 1:30, we're stopping right.
If we stopped it
right here.
I don't know.
Alliance is going to come after us now. The regulations.
Well, yeah, I propose a points reduction, not a DQ.
Okay.
Okay, how many?
Oh, so he's okay. Yeah, so here we go. Okay, here it is. I found it too. Thank you for pointing that out. He did have a 90-second version. Okay.
Oh my God.
However, he deleted that video, and I said, "Please send me the next video," and it was unavailable. And he sent me the video, but it was this longer one. Was that an accident? Was it not? I don't know, but that's the case. I'm on Discord right now. There's
things going on behind the scenes.
You know, he said, I'm going to read it right now. Sorry to read the exact thing. I emailed asking about the rules, but saw you in Discord, so Discord last email. This one is trimmed to 90 seconds, and it's a YouTube link. But when I clicked it, it was unavailable. And then he sent it in the email. And then he sent the wrong one. So I assumed it was the 90-second version like he said. It's not me. How did I mess up? Fuck everyone.
All right, fuck it. Let's give him like minus 2 points and wrap it up.
Minus two points. We can't be here all day. Minus 2 points.
Yeah. Chad gives him a 6. I think it's fair. All things considered, it's fair. If one of the choruses was trimmed out, it would probably fit. So we got no problem.
Yes. There we go. All right.
There we go.
Fucking controversy. All right.
Let's move on to the next one.
Positively.
And again, a hard hitter. We got Dark Sea to Flow with Pickle Dick.
Well, Dark Side Drill into Dark Sea to Flow. What a tandem. Back to back. Here we go. No, don't be muted. Hang on, it's muted. I'll start it again. Now I'm all flustered. Here we go.
But right now, all around us, and so compelling you never miss the fact there's no melody, is a music that is all beat, strong beat, and talk. It's rap music, and it sounds like this.
How many seconds did it say?
90 seconds.
All right.
Oh, yeah, this guy knows.
Well, let me get a sip of my Neo here. Okay. All right, ooh, here we go. Working in the lab, cooking a heater, conjuring a spell with the bookkeeper, brewing a potion, put it in a beaker. I'm spitting hot Viraga, just like a Vega, dropped like a member bomb from Argentina, grinding on a big booty, hot Latina, I'm John Cena in the back of the arena. Now let me take a minute to say bye to this Felicia. Review Tech USA, you're a bitch. Review my Tech 9, in a ditch. Well, I hate to break it to you, bitch, but I heard your latest track. It's a piece of shit. Second in line, so Kevin, even more retarded than Kevin. Bigger failure than Project 7. Top 5 detractor on whose bucket list? You tried to start a civil war just for clicks. I'm sorry, bitch, if this seems kind of dramatic, but before I forget, I still owe you a tip. Pull out your cucumber and give it a lick, but don't get too salty or you'll turn into a pickled dick. Oh, bye-bye. You fucking dick. Good stuff. Do we have time for one more? Who else? Who's next?
Wow. Dark Sea to Flow in the house here. Holy shit. All right, Meerkat, you first.
This was an instant classic.
Yes.
Everything was a 6.
Everything was
just
correct.
A 6 song. I got nothing else to say. It is just there. If you paid attention, you know what I mean. That's it.
I'll say six. Nothing. I mean, then I'm not doing this like it's a lifetime achievement award, but how can you not give that a 6? What other score is possible for that level? What else? Lemtex, you go.
Yeah, I agree. It's hard to come up with the words to describe how much I love it, but yeah, it's a 6 for me.
All right. Let's.
All right. Chad has solidly locked into a 6. So that makes it a perfect score.
Here we go. And that means the instant style replay. Come on, let's go.
But right now, all around us, and so compelling you never miss the fact there's no melody, is a music that is all beat, strong beat, and talk. It's rap music, and it sounds like this.
How many seconds did it say?
90 seconds.
Alright.
Silent.
Now let me get a sip of my Neo here. Okay. Alright, here we go. Working in the lab, cooking of a heater. Conjuring a spell with the bookkeeper. Brewing of a potion. Put it in a beaker. I'm spitting hot Raga, just like a Vega. Drop like a member bomb from Argentina. Grinding on a big booty hot Latina. I'm John Cena in the back of the arena. Now let me take a minute to say bye to this Felicia.
Review Tech USA.
You're a bitch. Review my Tech 9 in a ditch. Well, I hate to break it to you, bitch, but I heard your latest track. It's a piece of shit. Second in line to Tevin. Even more retarded than Kevin. Bigger failure than Project 7. Top 5 detractor on whose bucket list. You tried to start a civil war just for clicks. I'm sorry, bitch, if this seems kind of dramatic, but before I forget, I still owe you a tip. Pull out your cucumber and give it a lick, but don't get too salty or you'll turn into a pickled dick. Bye-bye. You fucking dick. Good stuff. Do we have time for one more? Who else? Who's next?
There we go. Dark City of Flow with our second, third perfect score of the day. Who is next, Sir Cat?
Next up. Also, this song was over the limit as well, but it was by a very little bit that I would say is not even like worth getting any kind of penalty for.
Yeah, it's 141. Because the actual
song...
Yep.
Yeah, right. Yeah, when the song starts, it's like 15 seconds into the video, so technically it does get to qualify.
Yes. Let's
it's just the video itself is a little bit too long.
Let's not compare. Let's get bogged down. And by the way, everybody, Dark Side Drill's probably still going to make the finals, even with the point deduction. So let's just relax.
Literally, yes.
Let's just relax, everybody. We're not deciding the winner right now. We're deciding who gets to the finals. He'll probably still be in the top 10. Okay. Let's move on positively.
Who's next? Next up, we got DSP's Get the Lotion Radio. With a song that's called DSP's Rap Song.
There we go. This is, I believe, AI style song. Our first AI style entrance for the Ka-Ching of the Ring ever. Here we go. Let's go. Oh, come on.
They go ahead to God, I hear it all the time. DSP's an e-bet, yeah, every time I come online. He wicked on stream, you're just that one time. So I play some mobile games, is that like some crime? I post a picture of my wife, but I need a bigger side scroller. When we string together, I get the stool because I couldn't hold her. Now Mike comes over looking for attention. Waste his time a few K, and now he's like bitches. Chat's going crazy, why does he come around? Acting like the employee's my cat, and I gotta go look around. Well, okay, it looks like we have a guest on the stream.
It's big cats in the house, well, mostly just barely. DoorDash and Ms. Vernal so fat that it's scary. Trolls always talking about DSP. What about me? Phil got banned off of Twitch, but I was banned for doing that suspicious activity. I know everyone says be Phil, but I'm just not that courageous. But rest assured that I haven't had sex in ages.
And honey, why did you make? Why is that you love me dearly? And the trolls should surely fry. Oh, I just got a notification from YouTube. What does it say? Your channel's banned for hateful slurs. What the fuck? Then no way I've ever done anything like that. Look at my face. That's what you get for letting Jews in space. I'm the OG stream star. What work for Kickstarter? Streaming to some retards, subs gifted from Madagascar. Three wheels on my white scarf. I've been in and have to stroke far. DSP king of stream times. Time for WWE PayPal money lower to spend my wife's job money. Pulling some hope and saying it's not my fault, just like it's my slogan. Now, excuse me, I think it's time for the little shot.
Oh, zipper. Zipper finish. Okay. AI style, new thing, right? How do we feel about the AI style? I would say it was not the best jokes of all time. Some good ones, but not like lose my mind here. I like Cat. I was banned from DoorDash. Phil was banned from Twitch. I was banned from DoorDash. Love that. I'll say four. I'll say four. Kind of a high four, mm-hmm. though. Feeling good about the four. Great four. Meerkat, what about you?
I was thinking of four. Right up until the cat verse kicked in. I didn't expect that to happen, so I was pretty surprised and pleasantly surprised. So I would say a five. I enjoyed it. It was funny.
Oh, Meerkat, pull.
So yeah.
Pull.
I'm trying to get it up, but it's loading, apparently. I'll try again.
Pull's coming. Hang on. Lemtex, by the way, wait, you go ahead. Please, Lemtex.
Yeah, I don't know. It's hard to, I don't know exactly what goes into the AI stuff, but I'll say a 5.
All right, there we go. The scores have been there. The poll is, get your votes in now, everybody.
All right, super cool. Just a couple more seconds to get some differentiation between the numbers.
Yes.
And looks we fun. Can call it.
Yep.
Next up we have, just so you can get it ready, yes. ALT, we got Frog Machine with a song that's called Snortophilia, or How I Learned to Stop Begging and Feed Catherine Burnell.
All right, let me tell you, Frog Machine is a dangerous one. Let me tell you. He does not hold it back. I'll say that in any of his previous songs. Let's see what he has for us here. Frog Machine. I'll wait till the poll's run.
Yeah, the poll is pretty much done.
Okay.
Chad has decided on a 4.
All right, we go. Here we go. Oh, God. The first image is scary. Here we go. Let's go. You saw it.
No, this is not a pregnancy announcement. I don't know who put that seed in everyone's mind. It's not correct at all.
You are my Kit Kat junkie. Your blood type is gravy. You are my custard lumpy. You're 80% cheese. My moo moo in a moo moo. Displayed 16 to 9. You stepped on talking scales, they said one at a time. The way your flumpy cankles melt down into your feet. You have a strange attraction, your own pull of gravity.
Holy shit.
Your fupa drags along the asphalt you barely walk. I feed you DoorDash with a shovel, not a fork. Next to me and cry. You're trapped here till I die. Ignore the pains down your left side.
Oh God! I told you.
You've got pre-diabetic signs.
I warned you. I warned you. Frog Machine songs are all that in that style, let's say. Meerkat, you first this time, please. Thank you.
Oh, I don't know, man. I want to hear your guys' opinions first because I'm split.
Well, some people might expect me to give that a low score for some reasons. But overall, I would still say that's probably a 3 for me. You know, it's had some funny lines, not the most catchy song in the world. You know, production was not the best. Video was cool, not great. That's a fair 3. That's not coming from any White Knight spot either. I'm not wearing any armor today. So I forgot my White Knight armor. A 3. Lemtex, you go.
I'll say a 4. Even though, you know, beating up on Cat, it's kind of, I feel kind of bad sometimes.
Yes,
but,
thank you. Ooh, Lemtex, yeah, Secret White Knight. I didn't know that. It's hype.
No, well, yeah, just you wait until the finals and you'll see.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, I don't even know what I'm talking about. I'm a fucking idiot. Yeah, once you see my song.
but Frog Machine does it differently. It does feel bad.
Yeah, he does it in a very, very bleak sort of way, you know?
Yes, he does. He does. All right, Meerkat, please.
Yeah, I'm going to go with a 4. I was split between a 3 and a 4. I think it's toxic enough for me. I like it. I don't White Knight for Cat.
Definitely not.
I thought some of the jokes were funny, but a lot of them I had heard before. So it wasn't really anything too shocking. Mm-hmm. But I enjoyed it. It was a fun time. I'm going to give it a 4. And seeing that Chad has settled on a 5, which is very positive from them.
Yes. 5 so from it. Chad.
Chad I think the... we can move on to the next one. That is by Good Chemicals. And the song is called I Can't Ever Retire.
There we go. Can't Ever Retire. Good Chemicals coming at you. Let's go.
Thank you.
Oh, okay.
Second decade in decline, mommy combed hairline, the hateful truth, so pandas use DoorDash tortilla. Direct capture vest, streak tilted gameplay, eBay sneak, X-axis, Y-axis, blame Argentina. Daily investment calls, low support, stretch stalls, garage and Zelda pants, channel member perks. Net code, input dark, finger petting, co-op, begin restraint, show me yellow, paint the corner, demon lurks.
I can't ever retire. Different trolls conspire when my parents expire. I can't ever retire. Curate teen enjoyment, casting unemployment.
Team Wings and My Clums podcast on level one soon sent by mail. John Frank C. Rail.
Yeah.
Half-hearted answer.
Oh, yeah.
Fruit flies can infest. No Jasper blood test fills. A family man and cats can't get cancer. Mature adult mom wife chaos from persistent life. Black mold still intact. Derek's in the wrong chat. Ambush screw attack. Charge back. Super chat. Pig roach and the horse who's all on teen divorce.
I can't ever retire. The lack of will. Feels like fire.
Oh my
I
God.
Can't ever retire. Billy's taking every cent. David Linda's disappointment.
Oh my God.
Chill, relax, stream it. Timely.
Oh, this is over.
Chill,
okay.
Relax, stream.
Well, yeah. Stop it. Okay. Kill it.
They
this,
knew
this
that.
Chad's gonna be up at it again.
Record. Okay. Where do you
oh,
go?
Oh, dude,
with that?
Let me go first.
Yes, please.
There is there's a point. Actually, somebody else go first. I got to set up the poll.
Okay. There's a point. Okay. You can't. Yeah, Lemtex, you go. You go. You're the guest. You're the king.
Well, let's see. This thing was just like a fucking car crash and a train crash, like colliding together. But it's kind of like I think it was the second song. It kind of works in its favor a little
yes.
bit. Where it's like, at first you're like, oh God, what's going on? And then it just like builds and builds and builds. And it's like, by the end of it, it's like a whole measure off. But so I'm going to say 3 because, you know, it was all over the place. But like I said, it's like two drunk people going in the mall doing karaoke.
Mm-hmm.
It's just a beautiful disaster. So
that's it's tough. That's a tough one. Like, would I want to play that and put that in like WPIG playlists? Like sometimes.
Yeah,
it
has its own kitschy kind of place in it, in the society.
Yes, I definitely so. Has a spot. I'll say 4. All right, I'll say a 4 because I think it definitely was intentional. That kind of offbeat to make it funnier. I'll say 4.
I don't know.
You don't think so?
I don't know. If it was, that's fucking genius. So give it a 6 in that case. But for me, it's a 3.
I'll say 4. Meerkat, go ahead.
Yeah, I would like to think that it was on purpose because there's a point where when something is offbeat enough, it makes it even funnier. And like when the chorus hit and everything was just like all over the place, I had so much fun. Uh-huh. And that's why I'm giving it a 4.
Yeah, it was art.
I found
Thank
so
you.
Much joy in this song.
Yes,
it's
that's
like,
the point.
I cannot even describe.
That's the point. We're not exactly American Idol here. We're very different rating scale for us and what is important to us. And the end, it's we're trying to go for funny shit. And that was kind of, it got there in its own unique way. You know what I'm saying? But anyways. There you go. Next up, Meerkat, who is it? It looks like chat is locked in. Oh no, 3 or 4 right in the line there. Let's let it go. Let them cook.
Nah, I think they're done.
All right,
looks like they're done.
That's
so
3.
They're giving this a 3. And next up we have the final entry for this segment, and after that we have an interlude. It's by Grandeur McGowdy.
Ah,
the song
famous.
By Dent Biscuit.
Very famous.
It's called Break Stuff.
Oh, okay. Grandeur McGowdy in the house. Fucking go. Come on. Hit him with it, Grandeur McGowdy.
Here's a spoon.
Ah.
Please eat my shit. My suggestion?
I know it's small. That's the size of the video. So.
Bonus point already.
Yeah. All right. Let me make sure about that. How come this is
Can
so small?
Can you max that shit?
I'm going to. It's 360 quality. Is that what we got here? Okay.
Here's a spoon.
Oh.
Please
no,
eat
it.
My shit.
Here,
my
I'll
suggestion.
Come on, zoom it.
Give me your.
Let's start over. Hold on. My bad.
Yeah. What if you put it full screen?
Then we got bigger problems.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. See, then problems. We got even bigger problems.
Speaking of bigger problems, shout out to King Eagles 29 for the $4.99 who says ALT confirmed chubby chaser. No. He likes his women robust.
No, no.
Well, that's what he says.
I'll fix it. Hold on. Give me 1 second. That is not the case. Okay, we'll watch it like this. Bingo. How about that? There we go. What's his name again? Grandor McGowdy? Grandor McGowdy.
Yeah, Grandor McGowdy with the song Dent Biscuit Break Stuff.
Here we go.
Here's a spoon. Please eat my shit. My suggestion? Give me your address. Because right now I think I'm dangerous. We've all made jokes about shit and thought about eating some shit. All those detractor motherfuckers that want to step up. I hope you know I know the tax law. And I'll upload it all raw. And if my day keeps going this way, I just might beg some more tonight. I got a million flaws. And I got Jasper DeClaw. No, honey, what are you doing? Hunt. No! Down the dishwasher!
Give me something to break!
Oh my god!
Just give me something to break. About your fucking fridge.
Oh god!
So you can tip me.
Here we go. Holy shit. All right, Meerkat, how are you going to judge this one? You go first on this one. You went last time.
Oh, man. Yeah, this is a Limp Bizkit song, and Limp Bizkit is my guilty pleasure band. But the thing about Fred Durst, the vocalist of Limp Bizkit, is like he performs it as if he means it. And in this performance, I didn't see the guy meant it. You know, that was what's lacking for me in a Limp Bizkit song. So I got to give this a 3.
I think so, too. I like the idea. The joke was there, but you know, the premise was fine, but joke didn't land on me that well. Lemtex, what about? I would say 3 as well. Lemtex, what about you?
Yeah, I think the build up to the joke, like the joke would have caught me. I mean, it did catch me off guard, but I think it could have been executed a little better. I'm just picturing like in Woodstock 99, I think they do this song and they're like, all right, everybody split up on either side. And then when the beat drops, they all like crash in the middle. So I'm picturing this song over that, and it's kind of funny, but yeah, I'm gonna go with a 3.
All right, there we go. The poll is up. It looks like chat agrees. 3s across the board there.
Hell yeah.
Grandor McGowdy. All right.
Next up,
break time.
We have an interlude by Mario Faker that is called Italian Lie.
This one, the reason this is an interlude is because Mario Faker didn't want to sing it himself, and so I sang it, and then we put AI on it. So all the lyrics are Mario Faker's, but can't win. So this is just AI style, me singing with AI style on top of it. But Mario Faker wrote all the lines, so here we go.
Did you tip the king of hate, and will you just take the member bait if the pig roach tells you so? Do you believe in Korean pop? Can music make the Slayer stop? Will OIC still support post? I know that chat's in love with him, but she's never going to hit the gym. There's nothing I could do. Man, I'll never take her to the zoo. Oh, you only old geriatric fuck who really needs a nip and tuck. But I knew I was out of luck the day T. Carter died. I started singing bye-bye urban style guy. Drove my wagon to the pig pen and left him to die. Then once at home I drank gin and got high, singing this'll be the way that I lie. This'll be the way that I lie. I ended singing why am I a small fry, busted in front of children, and now I'm the guy went after a cloud but got denied a lifeline. I guess I'll bake till the day that I die.
Big ups, Mario Faker in the house with that one. That was a fun one. And also, Bob Starsky, the person that did the AI, so big ups to Bob Starsky as well for that. Overall thoughts, Lemtex, please.
I thought it was really good falsetto about on your part.
The zoo,
that,
yeah.
That was really good. Yeah.
Big ups. All right, Meerkat. Yep, go ahead.
Yeah, I'd give it a five. If all right. Big ups.
Five. That was very
brutal.
It's
a zero.
It's a zero. Mario Faker surprised me with the brutal side of that one. But big ups to Mario Faker for that one. Meerkat, go ahead.
Yeah, we ready for the next one?
Yes, we are. Next one, shout-outs, my friend. Shout-outs.
Yeah, let's see some shout-outs, actually.
Shout-outs!
Let's not forget everybody. Yeah, shout-out to Jake O'Quinn, who says, loving this episode, we need to convince Gundam to make a song. His voice is amazing. Mm-hmm. Well, maybe we will. Who knows?
Please. No poll, no poll,
shout-out to
can't
Christian
win.
C.
Yeah, sorry.
Christian C. says, this should have had the Katamari OST-style song.
Ah.
Which, I don't know.
Talking about Frog Machine's entry there.
Oh, all right.
Yep.
Shout out to Luigi Nair, who says drill is goated, which is absolutely correct.
Correct.
Shout out to Plebs, who says it time music, sound ear good. Thumbs up. And big ups to Aid Robertson, who says big ups TBS and Lemtex from Aid and Becca. Shout out to Aid and Becca.
Cheers.
Yep. And the reason that's not eligible is because I had to sing it, so it's kind of like not fair, right? We decided it kind of wasn't.
Yeah.
You know. But it will definitely, it'll still get a lot of airplay on WPIG. Don't worry about that because it came out pretty good. So, and big ups to Bob Starsky.
The point is, we're not trying to be assholes. We're just trying to be fair to everybody who put in the effort to, you know, like submit on time and in the length that they were supposed to. So, we're just trying to fight for fairness here.
Yes, that's
if it was up to us, like everything is on the table.
Yes,
just send us whatever. We like
that's
your
the
stuff.
Best. That's the bad. That would be the best. All right. Next up, who is it, Meerkat? Hit us with it. Come on.
Next up, we have Enon Billington. Is that how it's supposed to be pronounced? But the song is called Derek is a Dent by the Neckphones.
Oh, Neckphones. Pretty big ups. Sounds very punk style. All right. The Neckphones. Come on.
Derek is a Dent.
Okay, there we go.
Ken, can you please say, ooh, ALT, I want your cum all over my beautiful...
Jesus! What the fuck? All right, hold on. Let's hear that again. What the fuck is that?
Cat, can you please say, ALT, I want your cum all over my beautiful... Bye.
Okay, I got it that time. First time called me off guard. Okay. That's a song that knows what it wanted to be, and it delivered on that, right? It knew what it wanted to be, the style it was going for. I will have to dock a point or two for the repeating, you know, I always say in a parody song, repeating is not what you want to be doing, right? It's opportunity for more jokes. We have to knock a few points for that. But overall, it was, you know, pleasant to listen to. Jokes were cool. I'll say a 4 on that one. What about you, Meerkat?
I agree entirely with everything you said.
There we go. Lemtex, please.
Yeah, I'll go 4. In terms of, like, getting a Ramones song, it was, you know, nailed it.
Yeah.
But unfortunately, that means, you know, the joke density wasn't really there.
Yeah.
A lot of repetition. But yeah, I'll say a 4. Good production.
Yeah. Big ups.
All right. Well, chat seems to be settled on a 5, which is great. So we get to close the poll and move on to the next contestant, who is called Jabroni Cult with the song Philanthropy.
Philanthropy. Okay. Here we go.
Waking up off the Hogan's in the tanker, right? DoorDash sitting heavy on my chest today. In the kitchen, check the fridge, something's missing. Cat ate my special sauce, she got me lip licking. Check my phone, my swaggots, and no, I see. They like my red shoes, playing referee. Directed the masterpiece that is my life. Hold me back when I try to kill my wife. In the office, greeted with a stitch of old feet and a tiny grease. Shit got me feeling nauseous, stepping over wires, all kids, sticks and capture cards. Boot up OBS on Windows 8, man, I'm working hard. I'm just a small guy, making 5 bands on the hour. Every hour I'm devouring. Don't you play me, cause if you play me, I'll make you publicly apologize until you say please. When I sit in my chair, I'm swaying like a metronome. Keeping time until you tip me, that's a business pro. When I look at chat, see no one is talking, I'll just call your mouth through an idiot for just watching. When I end the stream, I see I only got to 50. I'll end the recording, begging please tip me. To the remaining 200 people to the Yakuza stream, if every one of you tip me now, that'd be a living dream. Thank you. Will I ever take accountability? I don't know, but I do know that the tips go. Gotta grow. It's a struggle running 2 channels, now 3. But I'm a crowdfunded individual, so it's not free.
That is Jabroni Call with Philanthropy in the house. Let's go. Lemtex, what are your thoughts on that one?
I'll say 5. I think his flow was really good. The vocal quality was like a little rough. I don't know if that was on purpose or what, but yeah, overall pretty good. I'll say 5.
Meerkat Mob.
Dude, I was vibing with this song from the moment the beat dropped. I love this song. I don't know why the jokes landed. I thought they were clever. I love the bad quality production, like the lo-fi aspect of it. It was just like it hit the spot perfectly. I'm gonna give this a 6, man. Ooh. I just loved it.
Oof. Ow, okay.
I was
6.
Like in the moment.
All right. I was thinking 4. The flow was good, but the jokes didn't really knock me down here, you know. But maybe that wasn't the intent. But still, I was, you know, a 4 for me. A 4 for me. Solid 4 for me.
Sounds
what do you got, chat?
Yep. Well, chat is settled on a solid 5. Can't get more solid than this. So
oh, yeah.
Let's lock it up. Move on to the next contestant, who is called, oh my God, I'm going to need some help with this, Kamek Doteth with the song Curate Your Content.
Here we go. You heard him. Let's hit it.
I don't got time for this. 41 years old, it always drops my inputs. Fucking buggy neck. Some idiot at Comcast is probably slowing me down. The lag only affects me. These scrubs are fucking around. I'm the hardest working guy that you'll ever see. Excuse me, got a break to play WWE. I'm gonna curate your content. Gonna curate your content. Don't even mention the trolls.
Big ups. Curate your content. Coming in hot here. Interesting. Interesting. I mean, to me, is that an original? It sounds original to me. I never heard of that song if it was. If it wasn't an original. What do you want? What's the score for that? That's a tough one. Meerkat, where you at? You go first.
Oh, man. I was expecting to warm up to the song a little bit more, but I'm feeling a four.
Four from Meerkat? Yeah, well, I'm going to agree with that. I think that's a good, solid score. Very pleasant, but not like knock your socks off with jokes. What the chorus didn't really, wasn't that much of a I got to hear it again style chorus. So I'd say four. Lemtex, what about you?
I'm going to go three because it kind of builds up and you're hoping for like one like last banger at the end, you know, and it never really comes. So yeah, for me it's a three. It's an all right song, but you know, none of the jokes were knock your socks off, I think.
Yes. And that's one Fair enough. Yeah, good point, Wilson. That could be one that grows on you in time. Big ups to Hemek.eth.
Yes. The good thing about this is that hopefully people are going to upload their songs to their channel so you can go listen to them after that.
Yep.
And see if something's going to warm up to you. And you're going to like it more and more. Because last year we got Zach right at the end, the final song, which didn't have the lyrics on, so we couldn't tell what he was saying. Yep. But that was a fantastic song. That's one of my biggest regrets from the last tournament.
We were not ready for that. The world wasn't ready, to be fair, for that. And then when it dropped... And then look what he's put out since then, too. But and we got a Zach song coming out, coming up again. Anyways, what's our next tune, Sir Cat?
The next one is by King Jad, and it's called Detractor Roast.
There we go.
This is going to be exciting.
This was the first entrant into the Ka-Ching of the Ring 2024. It was finished months ago. As soon as we announced Ka-Ching of the Ring, King Jad had a link for me. So here we go. This is King Jad.
This is your King of the Ring, and I am the king, I'm winning this thing. And though I can't sing cause I'm new suffering, the real bill loving the rhymes that I bring. I'm roasting my peers, causing crocodile tears, confirming my whole competition's worst fear. So lend me your ears as I go for the gears, or I'm ending my rivals and gonna go careers. Let's start with that being said, I steal for the dead, to examine Alt's massive forehead. I'm staying ahead of an inferior version of SOK's Fred. Cause you all know when it comes to the flow, me or Cat Cowboy Ludwig and Darks to the floor. So get on with the show cause of this tier blow. So take a seat, Jake, go zip thing go. But Raven is squawking calls for the bitch. Just keeps on walking, but he's balking with bass of gawking, bars of complex by Stephen Hawking. Fantastic Mr. Sam, listening and wonders as a term asunder, cause challenging me was an amateur blunder, shots of my bars like a rolling thunder. Ooh. So make sure you bring your best, Bubble Stars game, Lentex and all the rest, cause this contest is quite a suggest that you're lacking the fire and I'm not impressed. Careful not to stutter, super chopper, leave you all a flutter, I'm as smooth as butter, whereas you're a drama baiting nutter.
Ooh.
Unlike Lars, I got the bars, leaving him seeing stars, hitting so hard like heavyweight spars, I swear it'll likely be leaving scars. Dark side drill bit lacking the skill to chill if I fell and feeling so ill. So give him a pill, he's paying the bill. I'll beat him so bad as I go for the kill. Bringing the fire and desirable others conspire to hardly retire, but skills that require are all fucking dire as I'm climbing higher and higher and higher. Lyrics I own got me standing alone, for it has always been known. The king of the throne has now set the tone, so time to step up to the microphone.
Woof! Man, King Jad bringing it. I like that. I like that. Cool idea, vibe. Bringing the heat for many people. Many entrants in the first Ka-Ching of the Ring took some strays there. Lentex took strays. I took strays. Meerkat took strays.
Yeah, everybody got some.
Yeah, what do we rate it, though, Meerkat? Go ahead.
Oh, I don't know, man. So the bars were on point, like it was well written, but the flow was a little bit like I'm listening to epic rap battles of history.
Okay.
It kind of didn't like it. I couldn't vibe with it.
Okay.
And
fair.
I was struggling to figure out what he was saying because if it wasn't for the lyrics on screen, it would be really hard.
Well, he's Scottish, so
I don't know. I know. So I don't know, man. Maybe I'm split between a 4 and a 5, perhaps. I'm not exactly sure. What do you guys think?
I think 5. I think that's a solid 5. That's my favorite song of King Jad's for sure. In terms of flow, that was my favorite he's ever done in that style. I'd say that's 5 for me. Lemtex, what about you?
Yeah, I'm kind of split on a 4 and a 5. I think if he went a little harsher and a little more specific in his barbs, I think it would have been a 5, but for me, it's a 4. I do like it, though, and I love the Scottish flow.
Mm-hmm, definitely. Always appreciate the Scottish flow. Looks like chat is... Are we fighting over it?
I think I'm going to settle on a 5.
Oh, okay. Meerkat
says
5.
I think I made up my mind.
All right. We got 5, 5, 4, and chat is a 5 for King Jad, the one from Scotland.
Oh, yeah. Next up, we have lined up Lars. Oh, he was a hard hitter last year.
Lars! Lars is
with
one of my...
David Beggy. That's how the song was called.
I was very excited to see that Lars put another song in because Lars brought the heat last year in the first round and the finals. But once again, this is not a Lifetime Achievement Award. Let's see what Lars has for us this year. Let's go.
She was 17. I felt exploited just like John Rambo. Cause I got used by Beverly. I had to jerk it all alone in my office. Cause I felt safe from Pandalee.
He did say that.
And when I get all gouty, my little Pandalee says,
cheeseburger.
She said,
well then guess what? This down here can remain a man zone.
It is a man zone too.
Yeah, well guess what? There's never gonna be a woman in that man zone now. Ever.
She said.
Your fault.
Oh, well, Jesus, it must also be my fault when the laundry is done, when I'm cooking delicious meals. I'm sorry.
Big ups, Lars, coming in hot. Not an Asian girl. There we go.
LT, how long was this song? I hate to be that guy, but you know.
Okay, the song
for
was...
For the sake of fairness.
Oh, okay. 1:33, sirs.
I thought it said 2 minutes. I must have been tripping.
Yes.
All right. I guess that's fine.
That's 33 like seconds, boys. 30, come on. Though. Yeah. Come on.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. Good. Because I saw some people in chat saying that it was 2 minutes. So I was ready.
I was ready to take it. It was 2 minutes.
Not 2 minutes. It was just a kind of slower style song. We're ready for Beg Yak, but it wasn't Beg Yak. We chose went a different route. All right. So
yep.
I would say, you know, it's not a Lifetime Achievement Award. This is probably not my favorite Lars song for sure. I would say some jokes were there. Didn't knock me down with those jokes. I would say a 4 from me. How about you, Lemtex?
I'm going to go with 3 because I think King Jad's was better and I gave that a 4. So I give it a 3.
Logic checks out. Go ahead, Meerkat.
I think I'm going to go with a 4. I thought the concept was cool. The idea taken from the original song so you can parody it was cool. But I was left cold for some reason. Mm-hmm. I needed something more.
Yes. Yeah, that Nocturnal, you're correct. That's a great song for WPAG. We'll eat that up. We always love Lars content. Sure. So. No shame in the 4 for that one.
Yep,
Who's next?
Chat is also locking in a 4. So we move on to the next one, who is the last one of this bracket or this segment that is called Magnum with the song Meaningful Content.
Magnum,
I believe this is a new entry. We haven't seen this man before.
Right, Magnum. In the heat, Magnum. Here we go. Thumbnail is scary.
This song is dedicated to me and my 6 days a week, busting my ass for content, working harder than anybody else. This one's for me.
I hate my detractors. They mess with me.
Get the fuck out.
Why? Asking cat questions instead. Of me, I'll answer that in gay.
I'm the one. Me. Free. Fuck you.
I hate foreign members and fake currency.
Hateful slur.
I down from the rafters. Who could that be?
Brother.
I watch me DoorDash while begging for money. I really need it. I, that's a stupid question. And a band, you see,
gone forever.
I got my bag stolen and the wheel from my car.
I have evidence.
You don't push me too far, you mouth drooling retard. I shouldn't have said that. I love my chill streams if you shell out currency.
Okay.
Wait, what did he say on the screen?
Yeah, King be cruel.
You fucking test me. Get a spoon from me.
King be bitch.
My meaningful content is what I see, right? Just another bag stream from DSP.
All right. Now can I concentrate on the game and have fun? Instead of listening to stupid dumb shit? That'd be great.
What's this last
your beat was completely off. Beat off. You know about that. So we're going to have to redo the entire song.
Oh, yeah?
Phil, get that away from me.
There we go. Big ups. I like the last little story there. And Phil in the recording booth there. Pretty hype. What would you say for that one? Meerkat Mob, you haven't went first in a while. Go ahead.
Oh, I don't know, man. I was vibing with the song itself, but it didn't really kind of stick with me. I don't know what to say. I don't know. I think it's a solid 5. It was a nice, jumpy song with some clever punchlines. Yeah, I'm cool with it. I'm giving it a 5.
Lemtex.
I mean, I'm not trying to be a hater. It's just, you know, the me re joke, I think, has overstayed its welcome. I think we can retire it.
Yeah, that's a fair point.
And nothing really knocked my socks off in terms of like catching me off guard. So I'm going to go with a 4.
Okay. I'll probably say 4 as well. I think it's fine for what it was, but again, no jokes that was like wow jokes. I'd say it was a solid 4, you know? Nothing wrong with it, 4. Yeah, and definitely Lemtex is Simon Cowell. And also Lemtex, I think that was a shout out to you with that the joke about I shouldn't have said that. Did you pick that up on that, Lemtex?
I think that's just a thing that he said, though.
That's true. Very fair. He did just
I mean, I did use that in one of my songs, but that is an actual thing, word for word, DSP thing. But if it was a reference to me, it changed my score to a 6.
Okay, absolutely. Meerkat, you back?
Yeah, I'm back.
Okay, cool. There we go. Looks like chat is very close between a 4 and a 5. Come on, chat, get your votes in.
So up next, ALT, we got my interlude.
Oh, okay.
We got a quick break.
All right. And you have to turn this one, leave for a minute to say bye. Hockey game is starting at some point, but I'll listen to this first, of course. Meerkat's interlude. What's the title? Any backstory on story to this, Meerkat?
The backstory is it's a remix of Kool-Aid Girl with somebody that I greatly respect and I enjoy working with. He's always on point. He's always clever as fuck. And I can't wait for everybody to hear what he has packing.
All right. Aha. Kool-Aid Girl remix. Let's go.
Kool-Aid Girl, my only love. Oh, Kool-Aid Girl, my only love. Praying to the skies above. Juice on your lips, and it's ripping on your hips. Put my girl in jail for so long. She did nothing wrong. I want you free, and I'm begging to the skies above. Kool-Aid Girl, my only. Yeah, Kool-Aid Girl, my only love. If I were that guy from the farming website, I'd treat you right, clap those cheeks all night. I will change your life, no more OnlyFans. I will be your only man. Free Kool-Aid for life, only for $11.95. No more living in a van. We're going on vacation in Japan. And you can use my hot tub. Kool-Aid Girl, my only.
Yeah, cool it girl, my only love.
My girl fresh out, looking so nice.
So
let
nice.
Me get a date for
$11.95.
Grab your van, baby, we can take a ride. And if we get in the jam, go out like Bonnie and Clyde, baby. Let me holler, girl, I'ma give a big tip. You can smoke loud on my cam, come and get this. We can take big sips, take a day trip down to the Costco, get some cool
A-mix.
Let a homie get all up in that crazy. We can hang out in your van, you could give a handy J like that officer you play, baby. Make it angry like I wasn't finna pay, baby.
Hey, baby.
Kool-Aid girl, you the only one. The only girl I want in my tub. Only fans giving me that chub. Little brazy mama, so brazy, so thug.
Juice on your lips, and it's dripping
nice.
On your hips. Put my girl in jail for so long. She did nothing wrong. I want you free, and I'm begging to the skies above. Kool-Aid girl, my only, yeah, Kool-Aid girl, my only love. Kool-Aid girl, my only love. Kool-Aid girl, my only love. Praying to the skies above.
Big ups. There we go. Dark Side Drill with Meerkat Mob. Dream matchup here. Dream team in the house. Big ups. That was amazing, dude.
Hell yeah, man. When I, like, because things, like, working with Dark Side Drill is so fucking easy, man. I hit him up one day. The next day, he's ready for the thing. I put it on a timeline, and it just works. It just fits. It just feels right. So big ups to him. And I'm sorry I had to retract some points, but, you know.
Yeah,
you know how it is.
Yes, definitely. Real quick, do you have any shout-outs to read? I'll be back in 2 minutes. Just got to say bye to everybody. I'll be right back, everybody. Meerkat, you're
all
in
right,
charge.
Brother, let's give some shout-outs. Now that ALT is gone, let's talk about how old he is. Isn't he fucking old?
Hey,
yeah, he's just,
you know,
falling
what?
Apart,
old,
basically.
Regarding the ALT old jokes, I mean, I don't think it's a big deal to be old. I think it was a bigger deal that he admitted that he was a fan of Stuttering Craig back in the day. I think that's more embarrassing. I just want to get that out there while he's gone.
that's a good one. Now let's read some shout outs. Shout out to Pigpen Lord of Dirt, who says, so much amazing comedic talent in one community. Big ups to you all and our awesome hosts and guests. Big ups to everybody who, of course, submitted a song and made this whole thing possible. Shout out to LR, who says, King Jad woke up and chose violence. He indeed did. That was some of the most violent Scottish content I've ever witnessed since probably Braveheart. Man. Shout out to Tony T, who says, King Jad be like, what's heavier, a kilogram of feathers or a kilogram of steel? Love you, dude. So big ups to King Jad and Tony T. Shout out to Mario Faker, who says, DSP tweets, cat co-op back on the table, boys. Really? Is it?
Hold on. How what? Say it again.
Shut up.
Say it again.
Is well, Mario Faker sent a super chat saying DSP tweets, cat co-op back on the table, boys.
I'm
blocked, so I can't
ALT's
tell.
ALT's scrambling to Twitter right now.
I'm doing it. Oh, God, I'm rushing there. I'm typing up a storm right now.
He was kissing his wife goodbye, and he heard cat co-op, and he's like, wait, sorry.
No. All right, let's see. I'm checking it right now as we speak live.
All right, real quick, let me get the
finished
with the shout outs.
Yep.
Shout out to Barrett Wells, who asks, any merch going to come out with the Chicking of the Ring, like the Direct Capture hoodies? Perhaps.
Ooh, perhaps.
And perhaps Barrett Wells actually knows something about it. Maybe that's why he's asking.
Maybe him.
And a shout out to Lyrical Thesis, who says, thankfully, Drill didn't stay retired. Hell yeah, brother. Got so many bangers. Can't even keep up.
There is the tweet, my friends. Kat and I have figured out what our next co-op playthrough will be.
Oh, my God.
I will announce it on Friday's Level 1 podcast, and I think we nailed it this time.
Oh, sure, dude. What the fuck? It's going to be the dumbest thing possible. If it's not a two-player game, I'm going to fucking drive to Renton myself.
Dude, watch it be a one-player game. We're playing Super Mario Brothers 1. We're going to take turns on the levels.
Yeah. Now, did you know Super Mario 2 was actually called?
Oh, what up, Birdo? You have any facts about Birdo? All All right. Anyway.
Just avoid the trans issue with Birdo.
Okay. Snoot is saying it's Power Wash Simulator. That's probably a good guess. That is one that Kat knows and loves, so it's not a bad guess.
If there's a Snort Fort mod you could do, then they could clean their house for the first time.
That'd be fucking hype.
Yeah, that would be the most difficult level, cleaning up the Snort Fort. Get on.
You open up the closet, it's just like infinite, like just goes back a million yards.
Never stops. Meerkat, I see there's one just a little behind the scenes here. You did miss one entry, so we have to do that one by Hijack. It's not on the spreadsheet. And I do have it here.
All right.
Yeah.
Let's just start with him.
Yeah, let's start with that here in this third segment here.
All right.
Let me get Hijack up here.
Hijack is about to hijack this contest.
Here we go. Segment number 3 or 4, whatever the fuck we're on. Hijack in the house. Let's go.
That wind, that rain is sideways rain.
It is freaking nasty out there right now. And it's only going to get worse from what we're being told over the course of today into the tonight. It's already been announced. All GameStops in the Northeast are closed. So you may be wondering why you can't see anything right now. That would be because the power's out. We were in the middle of making ourselves some tasty chicken quesadillas. The power goes out while we're making them. So we had half-made chicken quesadillas, couldn't finish, and now we had to have lunch meat sandwiches for dinner.
I'll tell you the truth. Something that I can legally talk about? I'll tell you the truth of the matter. Why are you gonna listen to their dramatic nonsense when they don't know shit? Just a bunch of fucking know-nothing idiots. Dumb fuck kids on the internet who want to create drama for their own purposes, and they can eat chicken quesadillas. My ass. There you go. Understand that.
Cat,
that
go laugh.
The world to me when I get a message like that. Like, it's been tough. You know, my life has been tough over the last decade. It has. Hey, stupid. I have depression, you dumb fuck. I know what it feels like.
Had to have lunch meat sandwiches for dinner.
So what do we think about that? Kind of a vibe, not exactly a song, more of a vibe style entry. No words there, but very, moments of DSP spoken word there. What do you think, Meerkat, on that one?
Oh, I'm thinking a 3. That's basically it. I think I agree.
Yeah. It's cool. It's fine. You know what I'm saying? Nothing wrong with it, but yeah, it doesn't, you know, I say for this competition, Thank You Nocturnal, that's a 3, I believe, but fine song. What do you think, Lemtex?
Yeah, I agree. It just kind of meandered a bit. It's more of like an atmospheric kind of thing, I guess.
Yeah,
I don't know, but doesn't really do much for me in this case.
Yeah, so very fine entry, Hijack. Who is next, Sir Cat?
Next, brother, we have the Misery Merchant family with the song Endorphin Rush.
Here we go, Misery Merchant. A lot of people are saying they're looking forward to this one. Misery Merchant, Endorphin Rush. Hang on to your fucking butts. Let's go.
Let me be clear. Now, I'm not a political guy, right? But this is twice in one year that I had stuff stolen straight out from under me, see? So, finally, the end of the shopping trip. It hit me. I gotta get this cranberry sauce, because I'm gonna grab it now. I'm gonna forget about it, right? So, I'm not stupid. I grab my phone. I was gone for 2 minutes. Someone stole my cart. My brain was addled. My head was being rattled. They're out of their fucking minds. They're going to keep getting away with it all the time. I was gone for 2 minutes. They stole my pumpkin pie. Just to confirm, I grab an employee. And they said, definitely someone stole. No worker took this cart. So I asked the checkout guy. It was like, they're all getting some endorphin high. No logic, no reason. Everywhere in this state, any opportunity, anything, they just take. Stupid kleptomaniac. Fox stole my grocery bags for an endorphin rush.
Opportunity, anything they can take. These stupid kleptomaniacs.
Dude. Mystery merch.
Hell yeah, brother.
Fuck, man. All right. Meerkat, you go first then.
Oh, man. Now, the first half didn't really get me, but then it kicked into some level of like Pretty Hate Machine era Nine Inch Nails mm-hmm. type of vibes, you know, yes. that industrial shit. And I love that. Mm-hmm. And it just hit the spot perfectly. The video was fantastic. But just because the first half just wasn't as strong, I have to give it a 5. That's the only thing that is holding me back from unleashing that 6.
Yeah. Lem takes your next. Go ahead.
I'll go 6 because fuck it. I don't know. I mean, in terms of my definition of what makes a 6, I think it hits it. I think it stands alone, you know, it'll live on outside of the competition. So I'll go 6.
Mm-hmm. Man, this is a tough one. This is a tough one. This is like right on the line. Because, yes, the first half, you know, but they have a lot of songs like that where the second half kicks it up a notch. And then, like Team Health, that song, if you know that song, same thing. But then once you get to the second half, then you like listening to the first half because you're like, holy shit, it's building towards that second half. Yeah, I know it's a long explanation here, but some people know what I'm saying. I'm gonna say a 5, though. We said we'd be stricter, so I'll say 5. But that's absolutely, that could be a 6 next week when I play it 18 times on WPAG and I get feel it, you know, and then you know like that second half is coming and then... I'm going to say 5. It's a very strong 5, though.
But you know what? You just made a point that made me flip into a 6. The first part build up to the actual drop. Uh-huh. I just didn't have quite enough of the drop, but, you know, we got, like, time limitations and all, so yeah. That's fine. So I think I'm going to switch into a 6.
All right. I'm going to stay strong.
Thinking about it.
I'll say 5.
All right.
Yeah. 5, 6, 6. Chat is definitely locked in on a 6. So there we go. I'm the only 5 asshole.
Oh, I mean, that's what it is. Your yes. opinion. That's why chat has a 5x multiplier. Because their voice matters more than whatever the fuck we say.
And yeah, go ahead, Mantek. Sorry.
I think just we've been spoiled since the Chiking last year by like full length songs. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I think we forget how hard it is to make a 90-second one.
So. Yes. Great yeah. point there. And also, let's get real. Like Misery Mitch said, like Meerkat said too, the song probably could have used doing that part again, right? But again, the limitations lead to not being able to do that. Doesn't get to hit you as hard as it maybe should have. Okay, but I'm still sticking with the 5. I'm going to be strong on my 5. But yeah, there we go. Who is next, sir? Cat.
Sir, next is Nothing I Could Do with the song I Love by Oinko Boingo.
Oh, Oingo Boingo. My song was also Oingo Boingo. All right. Nothing I Could Do was, you know, one of the most prolific song creators in the house. Yeah, go ahead. Sorry.
I know for a fact, by the way, we're going to have dueling songs in this competition. Cool. So there's multiple people that made the same song. So I'm looking forward to seeing how that's going to turn out.
Here we go. More Oingo Boingo. Who thought we'd get 2 Oingo Boingo songs in one ka-ching? Here we go. Nothing I Could Do. And Oingo Boingo. Here we go.
Oh God. That song.
I love curls and twirls, they cut my hair so good. I love curls and twirls, they make me feel so rad. When I get buzzed, I never feel like I'm a lonely guy in town. I love curls and twirls, they make me feel so good. When I see myself in the mirror, I can tell my haircut is superior. They don't look for answers. They don't want to jeer me. They don't track my spending. They just want to shear me. Isn't this fun? Isn't this what life's all about? Isn't this a dream come true, Cap?
Isn't this a nightmare too?
Nice. I love feeding squirrels. It makes me feel so good. I love feeding squirrels. Don't tell me that sounds sad. When they're around, they make me feel like there's a zoo right here in town. I love little squirrels. They make me feel so good.
They don't care about the accusations. They just want a peanut-style libation. Uh-oh, there's a problem, Derek. Wants the microphone?
No, give me that microphone.
I love it.
That's where it cut. That's where it cut. That's where it cut. That wasn't me. I like the woodland critters want a peanut style libation. That was my favorite lyric there. Nothing I could do is a lyrical genius. I would say on this one overall, solid 4 from ALT Insider there. Solid 4. Very nothing I could do esque. Solid lyrics, but a 4 in this competition. Lemtex.
Yeah, I think I'm going to go 4. I was expecting a Derek song from the start, so I'm glad he snuck a little bit in there. But solid, definitely strong 4 for me.
Lemtex always likes when Derek sneaks a little in there. Meerkat, go ahead.
Oh, shit.
I'm going to go with a 5. I thought the actual theme of the song was funny with the curls and twirls and the woodland critters. I thought the lyrics were funny, and I just had a lot of fun. It's a joyful song, and I was filled with a lot of joy. And the ending was pretty funny too. So I'm going to give this a 5.
All right. That agrees with the cat. Meerkat.
Oh, yeah, brother. All right. ALT, queue up. Next up, we have Oddly Shaped Fred with Evergreen State of Mind.
Here we go. Green State of Mind. Oddly Shaped Fred. Go.
Yeah, I'm up at Bridgeport, now I'm up in Renton. Right as to Seattle, but we never really went in. I'm so damn prolific, and since I'm still here, you know that I'll stay here. Yeah, they love me everywhere. I'm a friend of people, hold up to my Argentinos down in South America. Brought me back to that Latina, saw her at the school dance. She walks over to me, she starts to grind like she's whipping my pace. Cruising down our own street, with my mother wife cat. Driving so slow, while the BK makes her more fat. Me, I'm thinking Hogan's, hero of the true ring. Gotta match him up so that I can get some more bling. Say what up to Jasper, that on who's still faster. Biting those cords, let me find the water blaster. You know I be tripped out in my vest and hat piece. Tell by my jammies that I'm most definitely
the snort fort. My home where I don't get to make love. I look like a stretched bug. We're in the snort fort.
God.
My screams sound like I say, hey, Jew. There's nothing I can do. Let's hear it for snort fort. Snort fort. Snort fort.
That was actually pretty good.
That was definitely actually pretty good. Man, that was some of the most efficient use of lyric space that I've seen that we've seen today, I feel. Endless jokes there filled in. That's a 5 from me. A solid, solid, feeling good 5. What do you think, Meerkat?
I agree with you, brother. That's a 5 for me, too. I had a lot of fun with this one. I was kind of expecting something a little bit more explosive for the chorus, because, you know, in the original song, Alicia Keys comes in, and it's, like, really grand and spectacular. We kind of didn't have this one here, but I understand why. It's perfectly fine. I thought the song was funny. I enjoyed it. I'm giving it a 5. And what about you, Lemtex?
Yeah, I'm thinking 5. If the climax, like, really stuck the landing, I think it could have elevated it to a 6. I thought the flow was pretty good. The production was all right, but I think the joke density was good enough for a 5.
Yeah, and let's not forget that joke of you look like a stretched glove.
Yeah,
that
was pretty funny.
Yeah, that's great.
That's a very creative one, my friend. No shame in that. All right, what's up next on the docket, Meerkat?
Well, Chad has decided that this is going to be a 5, and next up we have Pig Brains with the song "How Low Can a Pig Get?"
Phil Collins.
Oh yes, excuse me. We have Phil Collins up next with the song "Eat Stuff."
Uh oh, Phil Collins in the house. Legendary Phil Collins. Let's. Uh oh. Uh-oh.
Another one of those days when I don't want to wake up. Litter box is fucked, her mall job sucks. I think he's gonna cry, now I can justify. Order it's a DoorDash. My roommate contract,
If we interact, we don't make eye contact. My best bet is to read a menu to
him. Oh god.
Another one of those days. It's all about what Cat wants when she wants it. Another job quit, clothes don't fit. Do you want chicken beef or shrimp? It's all about what Cat wants when she wants it. I think you better tip, her hunger won't quit. Another one of those days, swelling in my gin brain. It's time to complain and my PJs with a shit stain. Damn Cat, Taco Bell again? I better order that. Now it's time to play some champions. And if they fuck up, I just call up. Dr. Karen won't shut up. Your best bet is to apologize, motherfucker. Another one of those days. It's all about what Cat wants when she wants it. $100 tip, take a sip. Oh look, Scopely got all of it. It's all about what Cat wants when she wants it. Already spent your tip, taking a shit. Joe, we'll see you, Derek. I can't cook shit. Her suggestion is to order sushi. Maybe we'll leave the house next week.
There we go. Phil Collins in the house. Another one with great joke density. For me, solid five again. That's just a overall great song, great tunes, great lyrics, funny. Meerkat, what do you think?
Oh man, like I said earlier, when you do a Limp Bizkit song, you gotta encapsulate the Fred Durst energy. You gotta embrace the cringe and like go all out on the performance. And I didn't think this one hit it for me.
Mm-hmm.
The jokes were on point though.
Yes.
So I'm gonna give it a four, I think.
Sir Tex.
Yeah, I kind of agree. Like, it's such a unique song in its composition. You can do so many like weird creative shit with it, I think. So it didn't really do it. Go over the top for me, so I'm going to go four.
All right. And chat again is more positive than us. I said a five, though, so chat, you agree with me.
Yeah, hell yeah. Okay, so chat gives this a five. And the next one is Pig Brains with How Low Can a Pig Get?
Here we go.
Finally get to find out.
Pig Brains, hit it!
What is up, everyone? Hello, hello, and welcome. I didn't mean to jerk off! Sonic, get off in time!
Oh, camera's out.
Gotta get the stream off! Gotta keep schedule start on time!
Camera's been on the whole time.
Chips I was racing! I spent on chasing those clues!
I don't even know.
Nothing I can do, it's on my phone. I really need support. Bubblegum's done, can't work cause my back. I could laugh like that when the kids step out. Watch me sort and shout another big guy clean. Could you please tip me? How long can a pig get? Now, guys, how low could your beer go?
All of my money goes to Bill.
How low could the pig get?
Give me money, 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 give me money.
There we go, Pig Brains dropping the bomb on us all. Lemtex, you got to go first this time. Lemtex Cow again here coming at you.
I'm just trying to normalize the curve because last year we're at the too high. So I'm normalizing it. I'm basing it on last year.
Go ahead.
I do like this a kind of hardcore punk sound.
Uh-huh.
I like the overall tone of the vocals. The jokes are all right. I'm gonna go four.
Four from Lemtex. Meerkat.
I think I agree, but I'm not familiar enough with the original song to know, you know, how good of a cover this is.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I'm going to give it a four. I enjoyed it. It was very fun. And some of the jokes were really hard hitting, very funny.
I'm saying a 5 because of the use of clips. That was a beautiful use of clips in a punk song. Like, using the clips of Phil there worked really well for me. So I think that's a 5. I mean, it did sound that they knew what they wanted to be, and they gave us a song that sounded like they wanted it to sound. And so I take a 5 on that one. The clips really elevated for me. So 5 for me.
Yep, fair enough. We just need to get a couple of seconds more on the poll, because right now it's an exact tie between 4 and 5.
Oh, let's get your voice heard.
Difference first.
Go.
Next up, we have Pig Data with the song CT Escape. So we're going to be running away from Connecticut.
Sounds good, dude. Go. Thumbnail's funny.
Attention, all units. Block all major roads and cap all the sun
around about to get down. But Linda's all access got a dodge in from Texas. Off to Seattle, new Maduro, the life. Move in with my mate, one day maker, my mom's wife. My bank account's in the red. No point in saving, I'll rack up getting scared. Buy more stuff than I can track. Feeling air will fix my back. Follow me, handle it. Trust me, and we will escape from old CT. I'll pay for you. Follow me. FDSP, tip me, even though my content is shitty. My condo's new, all thanks to you.
Follow me!
Goals and detractors around every test. Red stank, but I still won't land. Santa has left me and my chat is slow. Can't cook for myself or even change my own clothes. My partnerships are all dead. Why pay my cards? I'll just go random instead. Imprisoned in a gated community, begging for eternity. Return to me.
Big ups. There we go. That was a very fun song again. I had a lot of fun with that one. I love the use of the background. It was Phil and Kat singing in AI style, which I definitely appreciate.
Oh, that was Kat?
Yeah. That was Kat in the background. Oh, wow. Absolutely, yes. I believed, yeah. So what would you say to that? Meerkat first.
Oh, man. I don't know. I kind of felt a 5. I think this is a really good use of AI vocal masking, because you actually need to perform the thing and then apply the AI on top.
Yeah.
And it sounded convincing. It sounded good. It was a fun song with some very nice punchlines, some very nice jokes. So that's a 5 for me.
For me, a 5 as well. Just overall solid. Didn't knock my socks off, but a solid 5. Lemtex, go ahead.
Yeah, I'll go 5. I thought the jokes are pretty... pretty solid all throughout. I like when the first part of the line and then the second part of the line kind of like match. Like, there's not one you can tell like, oh, I need to get this line in and I'll just throw this onto the one in there.
Yeah,
I think all the lines are pretty solid in terms of, you know, how funny they were.
Here we go. Looks like we got a straight 5 right here. Yep.
And yeah, looks like Chad is also settled on a 5. So we're going to close this one here, and right up next we have another break, another interlude that is called B-Sides.
Ah, yes, this is a new CD you guys can pick up. Definitely serious. Here we go, B-Sides coming at you here.
Ever wish you could own a CD of the best King of the Ring songs ever?
Whoa!
Well, that may be an option someday,
huh?
But until then, here's a collection of the best of the rest!
Yo!
It's 10 hastily cobbled together songs whose jokes were not good enough for an entire song.
That's robust!
And while Snortwave Records wouldn't touch these songs with a 10-foot pole, we do have songs about poles, starting with John Rambo.
John Rambo and me talk about big sweaty man. I don't care about pretty girls. Don't care about boobs. Oh no, they just do nothing for me. I fucking hate them, pantaloons. I think it's that whole vagina thing. I really love those hard penises. Please, John, just ball me.
When we asked him to appear on this album, the King of the Ring from 2023, Lemtex, proclaimed no, and he hasn't spoken to us since. And with that being said, here's I Still Haven't Reached the Tier 1 Tips Goal.
I have moved, I've got, I have made so many dance, so many dance, only to pull guns, but I still haven't got what I'm begging for, but I still
Due to overwhelming behind-the-scenes demand from a lot of people, as a special bonus, we've included a new version of our runaway Dark Dave Mirror hit, Q&A. Is it as good as the original? You be the judge.
Oh my god, yes.
It's not.
Q&A. Q&A. Every pre-stream you ask me. Favorite food, punched a bee. Who's the tallest man you've seen?
And it's not all boomer music. Well, much of it, a lot of it, actually all of it, yes, it is all boomer music. Including this next track, Cold IHOP Fries.
I love that part.
Even though I beg for money, you don't have to answer that, honey. And on Wednesday we play Dundoko.
Oh god.
After morning when we rise, eat a plate of gold, I have fries, and tell me everything's gonna be alright.
Hope you brought your water wings, because this next song is going to make you want to dive into her bush. It's Wife to Japan.
New hats, new lures, you get to pick the spot I stick into. Jaspers, blood work, I don't see a reason why. True bills keep coming and I can't pay them off. To take my wife to Japan.
That's the King of the Ring B-sides. So order now, and we'll send you the enhanced premium audio edition with 8% louder volume, noise gate, noise filter, contoured pop guard, and slightly reduced landscaper and AC sounds. Order today! Supplies are limited, and please note, leftover copies will be used as a Patreon perk that we may or may not fulfill. Order today. King of the Ring B-sides.
Check out the sites there, maybe go to Universal Studios, maybe Disneyland together, stuff like that. You know, nothing too crazy.
Big ups, everybody. That's the B-sides coming at you. And as you see the quotes, yeah, go ahead, Meerkat.
This got to be one of the most immersive albums I've ever heard, because I felt multiple decades older by listening to it.
Oh, definitely.
I got to say, ALT, you're probably my favorite geezer.
Oh,
you're probably
you.
My favorite senior citizen.
I'll take that.
Because, like, man, you put a lot of heart and soul into this shit.
Absolutely.
And also all the other stuff you got to do since now Sam is gone.
Uh-huh.
So, yeah, this is...
yes.
This reminds
crazy.
Me, I was watching a few months ago, like... episodes of TBS leading up to King of the Ring,
mm-hmm.
and fucking ALT with the WPIG like inserts.
Yes.
And the interludes and stuff. It reminds me of like Kramer in an episode of Seinfeld, just like going off on some fucking wild plan. And somehow it like all works in the end. So,
don't rope me in with him.
I love that stuff.
But just there we go. Yes.
Notice just the mere mention of the Q&A song got a pop out of
yes.
me.
Yes.
Even though Q&A 2 is nowhere near as good
no,
as the
it's
original.
Not.
The
we
original
knew
that. Is like it's an instant classic. Like the moment I felt it, I was like, damn.
Well, you know, funny story, goes way back. Q&A was the last song we put on that fucking compilation of the other one, and I always thought it wasn't good enough. And then we put it on, and that was the one everyone fucking loved. So we was like, all right, we gotta do Q&A again. Let's
yeah.
make it even worse this time. That was the goal. So anyways,
yeah.
you're all fucking legends.
I think Dark Dave used to play it when DSP was making a Q&A segment. He used to play that as a jingle.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, yes. That time.
Lives, I think. Yep. But guys, how about, what say we bring in a extremely special guest? What say we do that? How would you feel about that? Because.
Oh, no. Great. I would say no. We're not doing it.
Here he is. The one, the only, the Steve of the Shed. He's not there yet. I'll get him. Hold on. He's here. I promise. Just, he's in the green room. Get out of here. Come on, Steve. Come on,
Steve,
out here.
Come on.
Steve. Get out. It's time. Here we go. He's coming.
Must
in a
be
second.
That daylight savings.
Uh-huh. Hello. Come on.
Yeah,
there
he's
he
in
is.
His regular
yes.
Spot.
Yeah.
He came. Oh, let me get his mic. Your mic. Turn your mic on, Steve.
The camera wasn't on when I came. Hello. I came, yeah.
I can't hear him. I know chat can hear him, but I can't hear him, which is not good. Hang on. What happens? Okay. Hello, Steve of the Shed. Hello. Go ahead. You're live.
Hello.
Yes, he's here.
I'm not in the shed.
He's not in the shed? Yes.
Yeah.
So Steve will now join us for the rest of the show. Obviously, he's not going to judge, though, because that's not fair. But
no, it's not fair. No.
Overall, but, quick thoughts here, Steve, what you've seen so far. Come on, hit us with it.
I loved Flemm&M. I loved Misery Merchant. I love Phil Collins. And I also want to bring up with Lemtex, I love a good me-re. So that meme is never going to die.
I agree. Know, but,
One of those, okay. There's a few jokes that are kind of like, are we still doing it? Like the ooze is kind of past Lemtex. Would you agree with that as a fellow parody writer?
The ooze, yeah. I think this inserting the snorts, I think is, I mean, unless it really calls for it, then you can leave it out. But
yeah.
That's just my opinion.
A lot of people are saying that, to be fair. To be fair, a lot of people are saying that. Okay. Enough nonsense. Enough fucking nonsense. Let's get to it. Next up is who, Meerkat Mob?
Next up, ladies and gentlemen, is Pigpen Lord of Dirt with the song Filthy Flow, spelled with a PH and a PH.
Oh, hell yeah. So this... All right. Let's fucking go. Go.
He's just like me. He's just like me, for real.
I'm Darkseid's built.
It's a fucking fact.
Can be cruel.
Can be bitch.
Eat shit out of my fucking ass. No one cares about you.
Lick my ball.
Cause I'm Thanos. I finger snap you all.
Yes, bitch.
I don't follow your dumb meme.
Actually fucking bait.
I want to mill you a spoon.
So take your fucking taste.
Eat my ass,
bitch.
Eat my ass,
bitch.
Eat my ass,
bitch.
Eat my ass, bitch. I'm allowed to say whatever the fuck I want.
Dumb fuck.
You're an idiot, and you better wise the fuck up. I'm not taking
your shit.
Enough is enough, and you like it. Or you shut the fuck up.
Only right now I could buy a plane ticket and fly to Hawaii and beat the shit out of people.
Solid ending. All right, let's go to Steve first. I mean, just the overall thoughts, obviously.
That was great. I mean, I love that people can just make that out of the rant that brought us like spoons as a meme.
Mm-hmm.
It's incredible.
What do you think, Lemtex?
I'm gonna still vote with the people.
Okay, fair enough. Fair enough. Lemtex, please.
I'm gonna go 3.
All right.
It didn't really do much for me. I liked the ending, but it wasn't enough to give it a higher score for me. I'm sorry.
All right. Meerkat, go ahead.
Now, guys, I enjoyed this, but I expected the beat to kind of level up at some point. Maybe some like 808s, maybe some kind of like crazy percussions to kick in when, you know, it's time for the hook. So I was kind of left cold on this one. So I got to give it a 4, even though I really wanted to give it more than this. But, you know, that's just how I feel.
All right. I would say does it really go anywhere is the question. All right, I'll do 4. Come on, I'll do 4. I'm gonna be positive here. That was a 4. It was fine, but yeah, it didn't really do much for me, but I'll say a 4. What do you say, chat? What say you, chat?
Yeah, I think chat is pretty much settled on a 4,
there
so
you go.
I can just close it, and we can move on to the next contestant, who is called... Yes?
No, go ahead, sorry. So you'll be able to hear Steve next time. Sorry, he was too low. My bad. Go ahead.
Oh, me as well. Sorry.
Yep. Next up, we got Professor Puerl with the song Gout Today.
Professor Puerl. Professor Puerl in the house. All right, here we go. Professor Puerl is another person that brings in the very weird style songs here. So warning here. Let's see what we get this today from Professor Puerl.
Gout today, a crystal flare-up. X-Pound Ali fed me meat every day. Gout today, I need all your tips. DoorDash for the wife, it goes to her hips. I'm still dreaming every day about that hot Latina. I have lots and lots of fans from Argentina. Gout today, a helicopter company. Nepotism, use my business degree. Gout today, poison all the ants. Pick my ears and wipe the wax on my pants. E-clock cat Jasper is here, Bloodwork says he's feral. Re-uploading my old Vietz jokes are very puerile. Gout today, a quesadilla. My wife can't. Is built like a gorilla. Gout today, I really need more cherry juice. It's hard to find in the store. Whenever I get depressed, I unleash all my cum shots. Cause IWE, you won't be getting club shots. Gout today, a crystal flare.
That all I can say is that it's a very that's a very Professor Puerl style song. That was the definition of Professor Puerl song. But what do we rate it? Meerkat, you go first.
Oh man, I gotta go first. Okay, well, this was a nightmare in a good way, I guess. If you could. I like the vocals, the layering of the vocals, the AI masking. Was a lot of fun. There was some like really funny punchlines that I didn't see coming. So I don't know, man. I'm split. I'm thinking a solid 5. That's what I'm on, but I might switch up if you guys make some compelling arguments.
Steve of the Dead, what's your thoughts, overall thoughts?
I feel like we're unfair to Kid Flim nowadays. Like, when you look back at it compared to some of the other stuff we've had since, he wasn't that outrageous.
Yes, he wasn't.
So,
that line about the shots, it definitely could have gone somewhere. You know, not the shots. The there was like another level you could have taken the song to.
Yes,
but I enjoyed the vibe. It was very unsettling, and I appreciate that. So,
yeah, he had a special. His mic is good now. I got it. It's a special kind of vibe there. Is it a song, though, right? Like, it didn't really... I laughed at it, so I don't know what score to give it. Fuck it. Lemtex, you to say.
It was a song. You can have a song without an instrumental.
That's true. But it kind of like...
It had the structure as well. It had a chorus.
Yeah. So. All right, Lemtex, you go.
I think the uniqueness of it will push it to a 5 for me.
Okay.
It's not the most listenable thing in the world, but I think, you know, it's something different. So
yeah,
5.
I'm on board with that. I'll say a 4 overall. Overall 4, but I am on board with it. You know, I always appreciate Professor Puerl's uniqueness in their songs. No two songs are the same with Professor Puerl, and that's for fucking sure. But there we go. Meerkat, can we lock it in with chat too?
We absolutely can. Yes, and they voted for a 5.
There we go.
Next up is Revent Tillywink with a song "Will the Vest Streak We Be Unbroken?"
Ooh,
asking the right questions.
Oh, now this one looks extremely unique. I believe we have a live performance on tape. Live performance. Let's go.
I was playing Paper Mario on that hot full Sunday. I never would have thought that my vest streak would end this way. Will the vest streak be unbroken? Maybe by OIC. I need your daily buy-in. Won't you please tip me real? I'll out in the stream, hoping for some big tip. But losing my precious last streak is worse than post-nasal drip. I went downstairs, saw my wife cat. She sent to get DoorDash. Can't afford to feed this woman. Please give me all of your cash. Will the very street be unbroken? Maybe by OIC. I need your daily buy-in. Won't you please tip me real?
Big ups, dude. That was cool. That was fucking cool. And by the way, I know it's not, but look at his right hand or the right side of your screens. Look at the letters on his fingers right there. R E E. I know it probably says free or something, but that's fucking re and a tattoo on his hand.
I'll give it to you. That's a good.
Holy
it's
shit!
A good spot.
Damn, that was awesome. That was very unique, very cool, very positive, very positive. Do we give extra points for live performances? I say yes. You know what? Fuck it. I say yes. I'll say that's a 5 for me. You know? Wasn't the funniest thing of all time, but a live performance is pretty hype. You know? So I'll say 5 on that one. Meerkat, what do you think?
Oh, man. Well, I got to appreciate the musicianship and like having the balls to put yourself out there, playing an instrument, performing, yes. Writing a song, you know, is the whole package. I feel like I would be sinning if I don't give this a 6. I feel like it's my heart is telling me that it's a 6 because I really respect this guy and what he did for our competition to just send this shit over here so we can look at it and laugh at it and have fun with it. So I got to give this a 6. That's what my soul is telling me. I guess maybe I'm country deep inside. Maybe I'm just Southern.
Hype. All right, Lemtex, come on. What do you think?
This is tough. I think it's between a strong 5 and a weak 6 for me.
Okay.
So I'm going to say fuck it, 6.
All right, 6. And Steve, if you were voting, what would you vote on this one?
I'd have gone with Maker and Lemtex. I also respect the ability of writing the song with an instrument, and I also respect long-haired dudes with facial hair. So 6.
Always nice to respect them. Big ups, bias. Everybody. Chat is with you guys, so I was the Simon Cowell on this one. Everyone's saying 6. Big ups, everybody.
Yeah, but looking at the score, this is 1 point away from perfect.
Yes.
So this is
hell of a
definitely
score.
Making it to the final.
Ooh, new. Now you know he has to bring another performance for us in the final, so get hyped for that. If he makes it. All right, who's next? Sir Cat.
Next up, we have Salute Your Snorts with the song No Piggity.
Oh, yes, we were waiting for this one. Snow Piggity.
Oh, yeah.
This was one where I saw the title. I was like, all right, here we go, boys. This is what we're here for right here. No Piggity in the house. Come on. Oh, don't be muted. Play pig. There we go.
Play on pig roach. No piggity. Lots of gout, yeah.
Yo, Phil.
Yeah.
Shut the fuck up.
It's going down, no detracting me. Surreal the stream, they try to distract me. Exit doubt, I sway and slouch. Got the gout, ooh, ouch. My credit can't vouch. 13 credit cards maxed out. Only lagging neck code, stopping my moves. If you wanna eat it, send me your address, I'll mail you a spoon. Robust in flavor, hang with my family, Jasper and Kat. I'm the original Let's Play.
Jasper, get down. Nice. Now. You paid all the demons in the corner, man. Fat cat somewhere in the house, gonna pound town with Tyrone right now.
Oh.
Move from east side to the west side, in my Beamer ride right before I died. I think about Hogan in his prime, it WWE champions time. Getting paid for my Let's Play, the true beg away, OIC and Jade. Gotta get the tips, go in, no Argentinians. Going total wine and getting some gin.
He really hates working, no piggity. He's got to bag it up, yeah. He really hates working, no piggity. He's got to bag it up. He really
really hates working, no piggity. He's got to bag it up, yeah. Really hates working, no piggity. He's got to bag it up, yeah.
Nobody wants to look like you, dude. I mean, you're a fucking snitch. Everybody hates you.
Big ups for including that. Play on Pig Roach. All right. Let's go to Lemtex Cal first on this one. I'm interested. Very interested in what Lemtex has to say.
It's pretty solid. I think the production value holds it back a little bit. But okay. Overall, I think it was pretty good. So I will go 5.
Sir Steve.
That had me nodding. Can't deny it. That was good. I appreciate a well-executed parody as well. So, yeah.
All right. Good one. Meerkat Mob.
Oh man, I was along for the ride the entire time. I had so much fun. It was great. The rhymes stuck and were accurate compared to the original song.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the rhyming scheme, the syllables and all that stuff. It was just, I had so much fun, man. How can I not give this a 6?
Yep.
I would be dishonest if I don't give this a 6. I'm giving this a 6. I don't even give a fuck.
Me too.
Come at me.
6 as well. The lines were good. Great song choice. That's very important, right? That's part of this competition. Choosing good songs and just no piggity, right? Great. And yeah. Jaha insults adds points. Always adds points. I'm
so glad we found that clip.
Yes, just
so
add,
glad we went over that.
Please remember that in future chings. If you have Jaha insults, you get extra points. There we go. Chat, what do you got? What do you got? What does chat got for us, Meerkat?
Oh, chat got us the whole package. It's a 6.
Hell yeah.
No contest.
It's going to be in your head for days, isn't it?
Uh-huh.
That chorus is just, yeah. It's going to be stuck now.
No piggity.
Yeah.
And salute your snorts, by the way, which is a great username as well.
Yeah. Okay. Next up, we have Samurais with the song Lazy Day Off.
Oh, yeah. Get in here. Yes, here we go. Oh, yeah.
Today I just feel like spending all my tips. Pulling for some 6-star Hogan's. Don't feel like saving any cash. I'll drink some gin then get DoorDash. Cause today I swear I'm just spending all my tips.
Oh.
Gonna kick up my feet and stare at champions. Pull the new unit, blow a load in my pants. I'm riding on that money from dance. Cat crying in a room cause she'll never see Japan. We'll never have the money to ever make the plan. Cause all my money goes to champions. Oh yes, I spend it. I spend it. I spend it on Hogan. Today I just feel like spending tips. Pulling for some 6-star Hogan's. Don't feel like saving any cash. I'll drink some gin then get DoorDash. Cause today I swear I'm just spending all my tips. Pulling Hogan's. Pulling Hogan's.
Very intriguing.
All right.
Very intriguing.
Who goes first?
Mm-hmm. Not me.
All right. I can do it.
Yes, please.
I can do it. All right. I really appreciate that Samurais put in a lot of effort into the vocal performance. Like,
yes.
You can see he was actually, like, he was pushing hard. I thought the jokes were okay. I thought they were funny enough. I like the original song. I like this as a parody. I think it's a 5 for me. Feels like a 5.
Let's go to Steve of the Dead next. Need your hot take.
I'd concur with that. I mean, it's one of those where you get a parody. You've got the idea from, like, either the title or the chorus, and then you work backwards to fit everything else in.
Yeah.
And it's well done. It's well executed. And yeah, that was a good one.
I was like, it's like such a beautifully nice, great singing, right? Just the whole package was there, but was it wow? Did it wow me?
Mm.
Didn't wow me. So I'm just going to say 5 on that. Lemtex, go ahead.
Yeah, I'm kind of with Meerkat. The vocal performance I thought was really great. He had just a nice little bit of distortion on his voice, like a little growl to it. I really appreciate that. So vocal performance, great. The jokes were just, you know, standard. a lot of these songs, I think, just could get a whole point if they really just knock your socks off at the end, you know what I mean? Or anywhere in, you know, where they just fucking catch you with a, you know, a yes. jab out of nowhere.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to go 5.
5 from the king.
All right. I think we got 5s all across the board, including chat. So thank you, Samurais. Now we can move on to the last song of this segment before the interlude. That is by Sir Core. And the song is by Snort Style Core, and it's called Capitalistic Mentality.
that's a song. All right, here we go. Sir Core, come on. Get in here.
Do you think that these companies give a fuck that I couldn't get my money from YouTube because the bank was closed? Nobody gives a fuck about that. They want their money. But for some reason, government thinks, oh, it's a national holiday. We don't have to do any work today. We have our thumbs up our fucking asses, and we don't do shit. Fuck you. No, really. Fuck you. Every normal person has a normal day. All these fake national holidays need to fucking go away. Get your ass out there and fucking work, bitch.
Classic.
You don't get a day off because it's fucking President's Day. Now, I get paid by YouTube and I can't get my money, but here's the funny thing. But I can't receive money. How does this make any fucking sense at all?
Oh, breakdown.
Commercialism is great.
Yeah!
Spend, spend, spend. Capitalistic mentality in America. Get out there and work, bitches. Spend all
Hell
your money.
Yeah.
But wait, it's time for me to make money. Wrong. Spend all your money. But wait, it's time for me to make money. Wrong. You can't make any money. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. No, how about...
Damn. All right, that was definitely unique. That was fucking unique.
There is one big question. Was this instrumental made for the song, or it's just an instrumental? Because that changes my rating by a lot depending on the outcome.
Ooh, now are you, if you're in chat,
I don't care, it fucking worked.
Yes. Great.
They made that fit. They put that together perfectly. It was well executed, and the snort at the end just to cap it off. 666 from me. That
oh, triple six metal. We're going Number of the Beast style. It was funny too. I'd say 5. Great 5. Great 5. Great 5. Meerkat, go ahead.
Well, my question, I don't really know.
Cool.
If it was made for the song, that's super impressive. I would give it a 5, but otherwise I would say a 4. And right now I'm sticking to a 4.
Vertex.
Yeah, I'm thinking 4 as well. I think the intensity of the music and the intensity of the fill didn't really match up. If you got like super toxic or something, eventually it just really built up, but it kind of just stayed at the same level all throughout. So I'm okay. Going 4.
Right. Mixed bag.
I think chat is settled on a solid 5. So big ups, chat, for your votes. And we can move on to this intermission, this interlude, which is Steve's song. So let's see what Steve is packing for the Cha-King.
Steve's song. Hit it, Steve. Come on. Play, please.
But besides that, I do have a back injury. And so because of that, I have pain a lot when I stand up for you know, longer periods of time. In addition to that, you know, obviously I can't do anything like dance or do any kind of strenuous physical activity. I can't do anything like dance. I don't know how I hurt my back.
Definitively, when I found out this was a problem, I was actually playing touch football. It was a gradual thing over the course of my life. I never had back issues at all in my life. Both my mother and my father have back issues.
What's that?
Late 2016, early 2017. His back got fucked up like mine. He has at least 2, if not 3. He's really fucked up right now and can barely move around.
Really, there's no explanation.
Back in 2007, I had a full-time job for years, desk job, 9-to-5 job, and then when I unfortunately started getting back pain. Around 2006,
oh my God.
I started to notice my back was hurting. Went to a doctor, he took x-rays and tried to tell me there was nothing wrong. I said, doctor,
Are you out of your mind? I don't think you know what the hell you're talking about.
You can't heal a herniated disc.
My back feels so much better. The lower back injury pretty much is fixed. I never really need surgery for it.
I can remember when I was a small child in grammar school. For a full day's worth of books, we had to carry it on our backs all day long. 8 years of my life,
my back
was developing. I'm sure that might have been a contributing factor to my back has problems. I have a severely herniated disc between my L4 and L5 vertebrae.
I think it was L3 and L4, L4, L5 vertebrae. I can't even remember. Forget it. R4, R5.
Awesome.
Vertebrae. Basically, it's the vertebrae that controls things such as your ability to use the bathroom.
It was the disc that shoots the information via nerves. That disc was the disc that the nerves that controlled my bowels. I love how people think they know better than someone who's had back pain for the past 20 years, right? Fucking idiot. No, it's not called standing up, you dunce. It has nothing to do with standing up. You're still on your feet. You're still grabbing. You're an idiot. But I do have some pain in my back. I have a drink or two to numb it a little bit.
Oh, hell yeah.
What?
Hell yeah. Get a drink or two to numb it a little bit.
It is over 2 minutes, so it's not an official Chicken of the Ring entrance.
Yes, interlude style from Steve and the Dead here. I love how you pointed out where the disc is. I like that.
Yeah, he reminds me of Vincent D'Onofrio in Men in Black, the way he moves.
Yes.
I've been like working on it and on my video, and I got to a point where I was like, so Phil says he can't dance, so let's show, you know, a couple of clips of him doing Dance Central. And as I was editing it, I thought, it'd be fucking hilarious if these were sped up. It'd look so funny. And it just grew from there. And I'm glad to see I was right.
You did nothing wrong, everything correct. That was awesome.
Yeah, this was insane, man.
But yeah, that was just an instrumental track. That wasn't because, you know, I've got bandmates that will testify I'm not that great at writing songs, so...
No problem.
Well,
with that.
I had those clips. I had that song, and I'm like, I'm doing this.
No shame
well,
in that.
At least this year, it didn't get us blocked worldwide. Yeah. So that's an improvement.
Yes. Yeah. Last year, we hit the whole fucking Chicken Thing. I shut down because Steve did a fucking mega dance song.
I didn't want to say anything about it. Yeah. I was scrolling YouTube earlier today, and fucking a video of Dave Mustaine saying balls or something came up on the screen. I'm like, oh no, that's not good.
Thanks, Dave. Dave Mustaine, douchebag. All right, let's go. Meerkat, any shout-outs we got to get through?
Yes, perhaps. We have 7 songs left and yes. 2 more interludes and an outro.
Yes.
Let's hit some quick shout-outs. Big ups to Petchy, who says, I've power washed the styrofoam 10 times and it isn't going away, honey.
That's for the co-op style stream suggestion. There we go.
Yeah. Next up, shout out to Penitent Sin. Love that you guys put these contests together. Now I have a Chiking playlist for work. Well, that's very nice. That helps you get through the day. Just go for it, brother.
Yep.
Shout out to Good Chemicals for the 5 gifted, dude. Big ups. Y'all also had a fantastic entry.
Yep.
Shout out to King Eagles 29, who says, what the heck? ATL. These songs are so good and old. I love the boomer style music. Big ups.
Okay. Whatever. Not my problem.
Wizard says, consider this my B-sides pre-order.
Ah,
so we already got a pre-order.
Got sweet. I'll send it your way.
Shout out to Salute Your Snorts for the 2, who says, thank you, guys. Big ups, Salute Your Snorts. Thank you for your work and your submission. Shout out to Eisenhorn, who says, no piggity, no gout.
Yes.
Big ups to McDougal for the dollar. No message. Then we got Thack Milday for 7 months. Big ups, dude.
Yeah.
Says, this one stream has more talent than Phil's entire career.
Some have said. A people.
Yep. And big ups to 0207Z for the membership.
Big ups.
And that is it, fellas. We can continue to the next one, which is... Snood, with a song by Derek and Rasmussen that is called Feeling Oosie.
Go. Here we go.
Oh, man.
What we got in store for us now, those people at the Tractor Beam, they love the Derricks. They do love the Derrick. Here we go.
Sup, Phil, I just say hi. I not love to see you by eat chicken nuggets and hamburger. Watching you six, I'm feeling oozy. That ultrasonic gas quake, feeling oozy. Hello, Phil, son, can play Cammy. I got my shirt today, it's Chun-Li. And a time to go bed for me. P.S. Kazuga feeling oozy. A big fan Yakuza, no like BG3. IDK, I love this, I ready go sleep. So what new Yuton, how do Jasper and Cat too? Phil, I love you, I feel oozy.
All right. A lot of dedication to the craft coming out with that, with the Jade speak coming in, you know? Yeah, please, Steve, pull it together, okay? It's been tough. Levtex, please, you go first. Come on.
I'm going to go strong five on this one.
All right.
I kind of hate Derek. I don't know. Is Derek in the song? Is this all Jade?
That's fair. I don't know. Fair.
Yes. Yeah. It's almost there, but I'm going to give it a five.
Mm-hmm. All right. Five from Lemtex. Steve of the Shed, Bed, Steve of the Dead. Go ahead. Mm-hmm. Many names.
Oh, that was good. That was really just well done. Mm-hmm. I'm guessing they're all actual Jade comments as well.
Oh yes, I think they're legit Jade comments. Yes, and I think
they're all going to be legit, and that makes it extra special to me.
That's what I was going to say. Yeah, I'm going to say that's definitely because of dedication to the craft. Mm-hmm. Like that big joke, though, right? It did have that huge pop in the middle there when you got the der der der. I'm right between a five and a six for me, right? Five and a six, right on the line. Meerkat, go ahead. You next.
Oh man, this is really difficult for me because. Snood made one of my favorite detractor songs of all time in his previous cover of Simon and Garfunkel, that one with the, you know, oh my God, that was so good. And this just didn't reach that level for me.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm really sad about it. So I think I'm going to give it a four.
Oh,
just based on how much I love that other one, man, that other one was phenomenal. And this just didn't reach that level.
Well, I kind of feel slight now. I kind of feel like an obligation to say six. Because Meerkat's dropping fours. I would say...
Why?
Legitimately, that pop was good enough for me. Six, all right? Popping off, pumping off, all the offs, six. To the bank. Chat, what do you got?
Fair enough. Well, chat is settled on a solid five.
All right.
So we get to close this segment and move on to the next one. That is... Ya boy Super Chuffer with the Righteous Chuffers in the song Unchained Begacy.
Right. Chuffer, Chuffer, Ganji Kid. So many names does he have in store for us today. Let's go.
Oh, my love.
Oh, God.
Hulk Hogan. I've hungered for your crotch. A long,
oh God,
lovely crotch.
Oh God.
And tips come in so slowly. The tips can buy so much. Are you still subscribe? I need your money. I need your money. I've got two big bills. I need your money.
Chicky Chang Wang was added there.
I need your money to me.
Where are you?
All my money goes to Scopely, all my money flows to Scopely.
Lonely Riverside. Wait for tea. Lonely coming home. You basically murdered him. Oh, my love.
Oh, God.
John Rambo. I hungered for your touch.
An authentic Italian touch.
Oh. A long, lonely time. But we were just work colleagues.
Work colleagues. And this guest ruins every relationship he takes part in. Shut up, you.
Oh. Okay. First off, amazing song. That was 1 minute and 57 seconds, though, Meerkat, Commissioner.
Ooh. Oh, don't stop. No, don't make this so hard on me. God damn it.
What do we subtract from Dark Side Drill again? Just do the same thing.
We did minus 2 points. Minus we got to do it here, too.
Yeah, minus 2 points. Just 2 points. Yeah. I think it's going to get a very high score anyways. Let me tell you the beauty of this, the detail put in there. I love how the subtitles were fucked up on purpose, the back and forth. And there was, I saw a Chicky Chang Wang on the bottom there, which is something.
He loves a Chicky Chang Wang. It's one of his favorites.
He loves himself a Chicky Chang Wang. Let me tell you, he didn't get enough of that Chicky Chang Wang. I think the funniest factor was a six. A six all day long. It was beautifully off. But the love was there. And I'm really interested in what Lemtex thinks here, because Lemtex is Simon Cowell. Lemtex, please go. Kaching in the ring. Go, please.
It's another one of those where it's like so unique it puts it over the top, the stereo chuffer.
Yes.
The fact that he kind of looks like he has to poop his pants a little bit. Like, I don't know. They have,
he usually does. Kinda,
it's almost like they can hear each other. So I guess, I don't know, one of them was listening to the other and was like semi-aware in an alternate universe.
Yeah, it's a thing they do where they do duets. Like,
yeah. Right. You know, yeah, okay, yeah.
You're either reacting to one or you're both live at the same time.
I do love the T punchline. Mm-hmm. I forget if it like didn't rhyme or I wasn't paying attention, but I think that made it even funnier.
Yes.
I'm going with a 5.
All right, 5 for Lemtex. Meerkat, please.
Man, this was the whole package for me. Everything I wanted from this, I got. It just like good punchlines. We got vocal harmonies. We got like embracing the cringe and just putting yourself out there and just expressing yourself like unapologetically. It was just so fun.
Yes.
I love it. It's a 6. I hate to subtract 2 points, but that's what we got to do because we got to do. But that's a 6 for me.
Sir Steve.
Yeah, you have no idea what it's like to work with him.
Your colleague and friend, Super Scuffer.
Like, yeah, it's all about, it just pushes it over the edge because you're going full on committing, and I respect that dedication to the bit. And yeah, it made me laugh.
Definitely.
You know, that counts for something. That counts for a lot. So.
Yes. Mm. He's dedicated to the bit. Always it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I respect that.
Yes, as I do myself. There we go. Super Scuffer looks like chat is agreeing. With the 6 of some of us, some said 5. Big ups, battery exhausted. Is that good enough to get to the finals? I'm not sure the cutoff line we have right now. We're interested to see that at the end. It's gonna be tight.
It is ranking very high. I'm gonna do all the rankings after the stream, so it's as accurate as possible. And I'm gonna make sure to post them on Twitter. Maybe we can make a community post about it as well. Because we usually just post all the rankings and stuff like this for the different competitions. But yes, so this one got a total of 45 points.
All right.
I usually got 47, but we subtracted 2 because, you know, the rules and bullshit. Next up, we got That Obnoxious Ninja with the song by Foster the Papigs that's called Hate.
And I have seen That Obnoxious Ninja in chat saying that this is above 2 minutes. So... I know you submitted a shorter version like during the competition, so I can't really play that one right now. So you will be docked the 2 points, my friend, but let's just play it. Here we go. Here we go.
Yeah, we can just do that.
Yeah, yeah.
Still making fun of me. And when the tractors they won't go, they're watching to see me lose. But the dent, they will pay me. My gout, I say my gout. address so they can eat shit out of my ass.
Eat it!
And I'll mail them a spoon. And every day that I'm king of hate, I'm king of hate.
I'm the one.
And every day that I pull JPEGs up, I pull JPEGs.
I'm the one.
And every day that I beg for change, that I beg for change. Heck, heck, game is stupid too, but really nothing I could do.
There we go. That obnoxious ninja in the house here with the song. I would say overall, I mean, it was fine, but the mixing was really rough. I had to turn that way down because it was pretty there. Singing was okay. Jokes were okay. 3. Meerkat?
It had its moments, but to quote Hulk Hogan, that doesn't work for me, brother. So I'll have to give it a split between a 3 and a 4. But yeah, there was some fun moments. So I'm just going to give it a 4.
Big ups.
I think so.
Vertex.
I'm with ALT. I'm going with a 3. It was just, you know, it was just kind of there. Didn't really go anywhere, but it's there.
So yep.
3.
And Sir All right. Steve. Go ahead. What are your thoughts?
I appreciated the sort of like 80s post-punk new wave sort of vibe mm-hmm. they were going for, but yeah, the mixing was just like way too off.
Uh-huh.
But yeah, good effort.
Big ups to that obnoxious ninja. All right, I think we have 4 songs left. Do we have an interlude? Is it interlude time, Meerkat?
Not yet.
Okay.
We have one more before the interlude, and that's the Wolverine doll with the song E-Beggar.
And just to remind you, the Wolverine doll was the winner of the Gintro contest. That is the same person, just so you know. Not that it matters for this competition, just letting you know. Here we go. Wolverine doll, get in here.
Yes! I bite my nails and see that somebody is black. I lick lips and snort. Two detective men, someone at the grocery store stole me canvas bags. I lick lips and snort. E-beggar. I blame the net code every time I don't win. I lick lips and snort. Shaky hands, I'm jonesy for an additional soaking of gin. I drink a quart. Do you know about me? I'm gouty. When I'm not in control, I get pouty. Gonna scold any dentist down to doubt me. Gonna gorge until my knee becoming an orphan. In his memory, E-beggar. I'm scared of an urban American taking my tire. I lick your lips and snort. Subaru man loses lady because Philly decided to buy her. A combo number 4. E-beggar. I masturbated in front of the young and disabled. They saw me beat my meat. I can get ear infections like a toddler, so I gotta put on me neck phones. They're like a toilet seat. Talking to the film director Mike Klum, so I might be remembered for running out of the mic calm. This will be it is what I might have saved me failing business. Cause after the interview, everyone's only been taking the piss. He wants to show me wife who doesn't like to be seen. To get ahead of a tyco down and drag her on stream. She tries to answer questions as I hold back me snort. So I cut the lady off like a fresh pair of jorts. E-beggar, I'm tired of them Argentinians trying to cheat me. Lamon los labios. Gonna throw all the foreigners out. You Latinos can fuck up and eat me. I'm saying adios. E-beggar, me mom, I mean me wife.
Oh god. Wow. Extremely high quality. Meerkat, you go first.
Oh man, this shit was great. yeah, it was awesome. And it's also really hard to perform this fast and actually, you know, manage to get all the words out and fit them into the rhyme scheme and everything. Mm. It's crazy. I love this one. That got to be a 6 for me.
6 for me as well. Lemtex.
Yeah, I'm going 6. It's like Meerkat said, it's really hard song to do. And I do appreciate the punchlines are very curated. They're not like cut and paste, you know what I mean? You'd actually, you probably wouldn't see a lot of those jokes anywhere else than just in their structure. And, you know,
there's been work to make them fit in that structure because it is a difficult, like, rhythmic, lyrical sort of flow. It's very, very quick. So to get it that clean and crisp, a lot of work's gone into fitting it. And it was perfect. I was dying. I think I've herniated another disc.
Oh, great. Yeah. I shouldn't close it. I shouldn't close that yet, should I? Because I believe that is a replay because it got perfect score. Our third of the day, I believe. Here we go. Let's hear it one more time. Go.
E-Baker, I bite nails and I see that somebody is black. I lick your lips and snort. Don't detect a man, someone at the grocery store stole me canvas bag. I lick your lips and snort. E-Baker, I blame the netcode every time I go in. I lick your lips and snort. Shaky hands, I'm jonesy for an additional soaking of gin. I think I'll drink a quart. You know about me, I'm gouty. When I'm not in control, I get pouty. Gonna scold any dentist down to doubt me. Gonna gorge until my innie becoming an outie. Don't you deliver me DoorDash late or you might end up like T. I overpronounce that letter in his memory. E. Baker. That line is kind of remembered American taking my tire. I lick your lips and snort. Superhuman loses lady because Philly decided to buy her. A combo number 4. E. Baker. I masturbated in front of a young and disabled. They saw me beat my meat. I can get ear infections like a toddler, so I gotta put on me neck phones. They're like a toilet seat. Talking to the film director Mike Klum, so I might be remembered for anything other than Mike Klum. This will be this whatever. My auto saves me failing business. Cause after the interview, everyone's only been taking the piss. He wants to show me wife who doesn't like to be seen. To get ahead of a tyco down and drag her on stream. She tries to answer questions as I hold back me snort. So I cut the lady off like a fresh pair of jorts. E-Baker, I'm tired of them Argentinians trying to cheat me. Lamos los labios. Gonna throw all the foreigners out. You Latinos can fuck off and eat me. I'm saying adios. E-Baker, me mom, I mean me wife.
Man, that was an art right there. That was crazy, man. All the lines are there's not a wasted fucking word in that thing at all. There can't be with how that song is made, but holy shit.
Yeah.
Impressive.
All right, my friends, it is time for our final break of the day. Unless you count the last one at the end. This one is called DSP versus LTG, The Blast.
All right. This was a late... Oh, please go, Steve, for the big tweet. This is a late submission. That's why it can't win. But it is good. I'll tell you that. It is good. Let's go.
LTG, you fucked up.
You fucked up.
What do I look for when I'm looking for a good streamer? Man, they gotta be tall. Oh, man, they gotta have a peanut butter complexion. Man, they gotta, you know, they gotta have all perfect hairline. That's exactly what I look for in a streamer. I don't care what kind of content they're putting out. Yo, give me that fucking perfect hairline and the peanut butter complexion. I'm on that stream throwing thousands of dollars at that person.
I will blast your ass.
What are you talking about?
I will light fire into your ass.
What?
I will blow your shit away. And I will sleep perfectly.
Test me, bitch.
I will blast your ass.
You're an idiot.
I will light fire into your ass.
That's not how it fucking works. If there is a god, it ain't low tier god. If there is a god, it's low tier, bitch. You fucked up. Why are you talking about my looks?
Hit the gym.
You dumb fuck. No one cares about your shit.
Walmart NPC.
There's facts, there's reality, and then there's your bullshit world that you live in on the internet. There's too many idiots.
I will shoot you with zero hesitation.
Okay.
I will blow your fucking kneecaps.
Shut the fuck. No one even knows what you're talking about.
Keep fucking around and thinking this shit is a game. Try me, IRO. I will shoot you.
Whoa, 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 whoa. That's a lot to unpack. I'm being real with you. Fuck you.
What?
No, really. Fuck you.
What?
And I mean that. Fuck you.
Oh my god! Ah! Get this sorry ass nigga out of here! You suck!
Nah, you're not gonna get off the phone without letting me say what the fuck I gotta say.
Pussy here.
It's not even crispy lined up, bro.
You're not crispy, dumbass. You're crisp. The only way that your appearance is crispy is if you're dumping your fucking head in a deep fryer every morning before you go to stream. So what the fuck are you talking about? The word you're looking for is crisp. A crisp hairline. Not crispy. Use the right word. You sound like an idiot.
The only reason you've been bringing up that shit is for the simple fact that I'm going to goddamn Eva.
I don't know what the fuck idiots are talking about. So take your meme and shove it up your fucking ass.
I will blast your ass. I will light fire into your ass. I will blow your shit away. And I will sleep perfectly.
Shut the fuck up!
I will blast your ass.
Eat it.
I will light fire into your ass.
Eat it. Eat it. Give me your mailing address. I want to mail you a spoon so you can eat shit out of my fucking ass. And now you're low to your spoon.
You can't speak to me.
What the hell?
You can't fucking speak to me.
I am who I am. I can't.
Focus on your sexy, bro. Focus on your health.
Oh, that's so cringe that he would say that. I don't know what the fuck you're talking about.
If you're not properly groomed, you can't speak to me. On top of that, if your voice box and vocal cords never deepen,
you gotta be fucking blind and your IQ gotta be at least a negative 30.
There will be people who say that this was a good story. It was not.
I can say whatever the fuck I want and you like it.
Nobody wanna sit there and block the same shit for 3-4 fucking seasons.
Yes, sir.
Ain't talented. I'm talented.
Shut the fuck up. I'm not taking your shit.
I'm in Half-Life just like that. I'm in Half-Life just like that. What the fuck is this game? I will blast your ass.
Yeah, King B. Cool.
I will light fire into your ass.
King B. Bitch.
I will blow your shit away. And I will sleep perfectly.
Enough is enough with this shit.
I will blast your ass.
You bitch.
I will light fire into your ass.
Kiss my fucking ass. You're gonna say dumb shit like that in fucking chat. Everyone else who said that too. Shoot people in the comments, all my haters saying it in their videos. So now we know what you're watching every fucking day.
Any niggas ever try to pull up to my shit.
You dumb fuck.
I will shoot.
Shut the fuck up. No one cares about your bitch ass meanie bill.
Blow your fucking kneecaps out.
End it and beat the manga without any resolution to the plot lines. Oh yeah. You got
I can see you. Argentina.
There we go. The Blast by I'm 41 in the house. My only complaint is you make DSP look too cool in this picture. He looks like he is kind of a badass here. We need more patchiness, more gray, more short sacks. You know? Yeah, yeah. You know,
looks
kind of too cool. But there we go. That was I'm 41 with The Blast. Mirka, I'm gonna take a quick schedule change. The other interlude is super short and it doesn't really fit the ending, so I'm gonna play that now too, if you don't mind.
All right, hit it.
This was by Bob Starsky. This is a tandem mix-up from Nerd Brew, Bob Starsky, and myself. There's a new TV show coming out, guys. I don't know if you heard about it, but here is the initial, the theme song has been released, and we're going to play it for you right here. Let's fucking go. Come on.
Mr. Swaggins did a 25-bit chair and says, "If I don't know if you ever answered this, but did you ever watch Friends?" Yes, I did. I love watching Friends from back in the day. Sitcoms are good to watch in bed.
So no one told you Argentinians are fake. The joke is broke. Contractors MIA. It started with a bit of a Metal Gear. Though we haven't tipped today, this week, this month, or even this year, but I'll be there for you.
You know it's a bore.
I'll be there for you.
Don't care about your snore.
He says hello.
There we go. In the house here. Check out that show when it comes out. Come out here. The Dents.
Very
in the
good.
House. All right.
Yeah, no friends.
No friends. There we go. All right, Meerkat, who we got next? I think we have three or four songs left.
That is correct, sir. We have three songs left, and the first one is by Tina, and it's called Jeans.
Here we go. Oh, thumbnail is a mysterious one. Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
She wants to eat some more. She wants to eat some more.
Yes!
She
wants to eat some more. Yes, yes, yes. More! Oh, God. Come on. Broccoli with test! Holy shit! No!
No! Ooh, jeans, ignore.
Oh, come on!
Jesus!
Getting fat.
One,
stealing food from me.
Two,
stealing food from me.
Three, zero,
stealing food from me.
Four,
stealing food from me.
One,
Catherine's got too big.
Two,
Catherine's got too big.
Three,
Catherine's got too big. Her blue jeans don't fit no more. Her blue jeans don't fit no more. Her blue jeans
Holy
don't
shit,
fit
man.
No more. Her blue jeans don't fit no more. Her blue jeans don't fit no more. Her blue jeans don't fit no more. Cat.
All right. In my heart, oh my god, the last frame. There was something in the last frame. Oh, that's the last frame. Don't think you can sneak it by me, motherfucker. All right, my heart says zero, but my brain says six. I will be. That's a masterpiece in what it wanted to portray. The story it wanted to tell was told very well. Now, I don't agree with the story it told, but that was amazing. That was a six. Absolutely. Meerkat, go ahead.
I love this. The vocals were terrible in the absolutely best way possible. It made it so much more fun. The video is fantastic. I laughed my ass off. The lyrics are great. The topic is great.
Yes.
And it's a classic song. Everybody knows it. I mean, come on. It's a fucking six.
That was a great choice. Everything. Okay, I've already said enough about it. Lemtex, go ahead.
Yeah, I mean, we were talking about the Limp Bizkit songs, like where you really got to hit it at the right spots for these type of songs. This one definitely hit it. I think if it was the entire song was just the intro of Cat having food thrown at her for like a minute and a half, I think it would be a seven, but I'll give it a six.
All right. And Steve of the Dead, what do you think here?
Yeah, Wilson Tortosari chat said drowning pools. That's just spot on. That was amazing. I'm with Maker. I loved it. Everything. It was so bad. It was good. The video was incredible. The like healthy stuff like carrots and broccoli and that flying pasta. Yeah. Everything's perfect.
Here we go. You know what time it is. It's instant replay. Let's go.
She wants to eat some more.
Once this hit, I'm like, oh no.
Yeah. Once it clicked in.
Yeah.
God.
I knew she was gonna take heat today. I knew it.
Jeans, ignore. Can't fit no more. Getting fat.
One,
stealing food from me.
Two,
stealing food from me.
Three,
stealing food from me.
Four,
stealing food from me.
One,
Catherine's got too big.
Two,
Catherine's got too big.
Three,
Catherine's got too big.
Fat!
Her blue jeans don't fit no more. Her blue jeans don't fit no more. Her blue jeans don't fit no
more.
Her blue jeans don't fit no more. Her blue jeans don't fit no more. Her blue jeans don't fit no more.
Not this.
Also, I don't approve. like I mentioned earlier, there's a sweet spot of being offbeat. And yes. that first, like the pre-chorus yeah, yeah. building up, being offbeat, it made it so much better for me. I don't even know why. It's just yes. like it hit the spot.
Very toxic. Very toxic. Toxic. All right. Meerkat, I think we have Xenicat right now, right?
Yes, that is correct. With All Gout Boy with the song Eat It.
Eat It. I wonder where we're going here. All right, here we go.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
They told me stop, it's getting really cringe in here. You're sounding like a meme on God for real. No, I'm not a meme, I really have deja vu.
The characters in that game are going through what I have factually gone through.
I'm not gonna keep taking your shit on my stream. If this is how you act, you are the real me. You are only tough from behind your TV screen.
Oh, he's doing a meme. Oh, this is cringe. Shut the fuck up!
And eat it, eat it. I'll send you a spoon, you'll need it. Scoop shit out my ass and lick my balls. All your mouth drooling, Neanderthals. Just eat it.
Fuck.
Eat it.
Just eat it.
Eat it.
Don't like the game, you better leave before you're banned. Little King B, bitch, you're not a real fan. If you wanna stay and chill, better tip what you can. So tip me.
Please and thank you.
Alright, now guys.
Look at these idiots here in my chat, telling me, oh, you can't say that. Just because I'm DSP, a candy car fact.
I don't care who the fuck it is.
Shut the fuck up and eat it, eat it. Or you're gonna get the leaning. To all my detractors, come test me, bitch. You're not as scary as that sexy.
Nice.
Woo, mama. We are on fire right now. We are on fire. What do we say? Lem, take you first.
Fuck. Really, really quality punchlines. Yes. Really appreciate those. So, I'm going 6.
All right, Meerkat Mob.
Oh man, initially I was gonna complain about like the vocals and stuff, but then the sweet German style accent crept through, and man, it was so much fun. Like this song is just a ton of fun. I can't not give it a 6.
Me too. It just it's you know the punchlines were so fucking good. You know the punchlines were just extremely on point. Nothing you can say about that. Steve of the Dead, please comment.
You know how earlier you were talking about like when memes die and when certain ones occur. I'm glad this one that people are getting so much mileage out of Eat It.
Yes.
I'm really glad this is a thing because that was fucking beautiful.
Great.
It's amazing.
And we are getting another instant replay, my friends. I believe, is that 3 in a row now?
That is... Yep. Yes, that is correct. 3 in a row. Holy
all
shit.
All right. And I'm just going to let you know our last entry is from Zachary Burgett, who...
Oh, yes.
We could have
I'm so excited for this one because he sent it to me on Instagram like 2 months ago and he wanted me to hear it. And I told him, dude, like, I can't hear it. I really want to, but I can't hear it. I'm not allowed to. So finally, I get to hear it. And he's been coming through with some like incredible shit. Like the Gowdy Wrong, the Gowdy Road song with the music video. It was so fucking good, man.
Here we go. Replay of Eat It by All Gout Boy Xenicat. Let's fucking go. Come on, one more time. Get the hype.
They told me stop, it's getting really cringe in here. You're sounding like a meme on God for real No, I'm not a meme, I really have deja vu.
The characters in that game are going through what I have factually gone through.
I'm not gonna keep taking your shit on my stream. If this is how you act, you are the real meme.
Great.
You are only tough from behind your TV screen.
Oh, he's doing a meme. Oh, this is cringe. Shut the fuck up.
And eat it, eat it. I'll send you a spoon, you'll need it. Scoop shit out my ass and lick my balls. All your mouth drooling, Neanderthals. Just eat it.
Eat it.
Just eat it.
Eat it.
Don't like the game, you better leave before you're banned. Little King B, bitch, you're not a real fan. If you wanna stay and chill, better tip what you can. So tip me.
Please and thank you.
Alright, now guys.
Look at these idiots here in my chat, telling me, oh, you can't say that. Just because I'm DSP at Candy Carfact.
I don't care who the fuck it is. Shut the fuck up
and eat it. Eat it. Or you're gonna get the leaning. To all my detractors, come test me, bitch. You're not as scary as that sexy fridge. Just eat it.
Brilliant. Masterpiece right there. Great one there from ZennyCat. Are you ready, my friends? The last song of the day. Going to the one, the only, Zachary Burgett here. Stationary Stole My Girl is the name of this one. God. And there's no video for this. I just want to make sure there's no video for this, correct? There's no video for this?
Oh, no.
Fuck. We don't have a video here for this one, so we're just going to have to listen. But here we go. This is an audio-style song. Just listen. I assumed it had a video, but it did not. Here we go. Play, please. Hello. Here we go. Hang on. It's coming. Working towards it. Play, please. There we go.
I heard someone screaming from my wife's room. The mattress rocked.
Amazing.
Oh.
On. Come on. All right, I'm not going first. Meerkat, you go.
Bro, I love it. I love it. This is the type of creativity I like in these competitions. It's fantastic. Of course, there's no video, which is kind of a drawback, but it yes. still doesn't hold it back for me. So I gotta give it a 6, man. I love these kind of songs. The creativity, like putting everything together yourself, is just something else, man. It's crazy.
Okay, so what do we can do? Okay, so what do you think, Lemtex? You go first next. Come on, Lemtex, hit us.
I can't not give it a 6. I mean, hopefully we get a full version eventually. But yeah, I mean, just the mixing, the originality of it. You know, big ups, Zach.
Big up, Zach. Steve of the Dead, what do you think?
Yeah, it nailed that sort of psychedelic rock, experimental, you know, like Cream, Coven, Arthur Brown, that sort of thing where you're like, you know what? I'm perfectly fine to ever smoke and listen to this. So, very much my shit, yeah.
There we go. I guess we have to say 6 just because it's so unique and it's just... This is really the one where if you listen to it 4 more times, then you're going to be like, all right, now I see the real genius of it. So I think you have to give it a 6. And also, you know, it'd be nice to get them in the finals too, because I know every single song they do is sixable, you know, is six worthy. And this is a 6 again. I wish I had a full version though. It's very short. It's right on the line 5 and 6 for me, you know what I'm saying? But I'll be positive and say 6, you know? Here's the lyrics here. As we listen to it one more time, you can see amazing. Exactly what they're saying, and it'll make it even better. So here we go.
I heard someone screaming from my wife's room. The mattress rocked.
That bass.
I opened up the door and found her on her hooves and knees. Wide-eyed, frozen right where I stood. I know I've never been so good. Even though I was patient.
please make a full version. Yeah. Please, full version. We gotta have that.
This that is, was imagine the pop we would get if we had the lyrics for the last song on the previous Ja-King, because those were fantastic and the song was awesome. We just couldn't tell what was happening.
The mix on this one was definitely a lot better.
Cleaner too.
Yeah, agree.
All right, my friends. That is the entire Ka-Ching of the Ring 2. Round one has been completed. Before we get to the outro, Meerkat, let's get the shout-outs before we say bye to everybody, please.
Hell yeah, brother. So, shout-out to Larry B., who says, gotta give extra credit to the live banjo entry for the inside Phil's irrational hatred for the BioShock extra scene.
Definitely.
Yeah, big ups to that performance. Definitely. That was fantastic performance. Shout out to Inan Billington, who says, thanks for listening to my dumb song, fellas. Well, your dumb song was very fun. I think you rated it very highly, I think. Next up, we got King Eagles 29. Big ups. Haha, authentic Italian touch, John Rambo style.
Yeah, you're not free yet, Lyrical Thesis. We do have one outro song coming at you, but go ahead, Meerkat, continue.
Yeah. Shout out to CEO Philosopher for the membership, Disgruntled Frenchman for 12 months. That's a whole year, dude. Crazy. And shout out to Bort License Plates, who says, this entire establishment is going to hell.
Agreed.
And I'm coming with.
Nice.
So yeah, welcome aboard. And then he says, sends another 20 and says, give all this money to Meerkat Mob, LMAO.
That's
legit.
Already done. Sure,
thanks.
Yeah,
it's better than a payday.
Yeah. So yeah. Yep. Anything else, Meerkat?
Make sure. That's it, you guys. Okay, cool. We can close it off.
All right. So here's the thing we're gonna do. Of course, we're gonna tabulate scores, make sure it's perfect, and then let you know on Twitter later or tomorrow when Meerkat counts it all up. Who's the top 10? Then we'll decide a date on that, and then it's finals time. So that was it. Steve, before we get to our outro song here, let's say bye to everybody, because that's kind of after the outro. I just want to go right to the outro and see you later. So Steve of the Dead, any final words, please?
This was fun. I'm glad I got to join you and get some amazing laughs out of some amazingly talented people. And yeah, thanks for all the love and support, everybody. I'll be back soon.
Yeah,
doing all right with rehab and physio. So, you know,
big ups. Always nice to have you with us, brother. Lemtech, Sir Ka-Ching 2023. Final words, please.
Yeah, thanks for having me. I really enjoyed my time. For the finals, I'll have a song for you guys. So until then, have a nice evening. Steve, feel better. And good night, everybody.
Yep, Lemtech will be with us for the finals. And Lemtech's song. Meerkat, any final words?
Yes, thank you, everybody, for all this work that you put in your entries.
Mm-hmm.
They were fantastic. We had so much fun. I hope you had as much fun making them as we had listening to them. I hope people watching had fun. No hard feelings. If you disagree with our ratings, it's just how we felt about it.
Yes.
I actually have some statistics about it. I can tell you who was the most positive and who was the most toxified.
Oh, nice.
So Lemtex has a total score of 172.
Okay.
Over all the songs, which makes him the most toxified.
Ah, woo! Let's go!
Yeah. We got ALT has a 178, and I have a 184, which makes me the most positive. And ALT is riding the fence.
Uh-huh, always riding the fence. By the way, Sunday we'll have a show again. Something with the interview. We haven't decided yet, so we'll see you on Sunday, hopefully. And we got an outro song ready for you. And just like last year, I did the same kind of thing I did. Made it as sad as possible. Chu is not with us this time, sadly. But I made it as sad as possible. And let's have some fun. Thanks, everybody, for joining us. It was an amazing time. I look forward to this more than anyone else, I promise you. And it's all because of you guys making the songs out there. And I'll be listening to them all fucking year on WPIG. So thank you so much, everybody. You're all fucking legends, all right? Let's get to the outro here. Last song of the day. And this is entitled, I fucking forget. It's called The Outro. Let's go. See you guys.
When my now wife Kat moved in with me over 2 years ago, I said I'm basically not going to be playing these games with any kind of major time investment or money investment anymore. At that point, I couldn't do money investment anyway. I was broke. But basically, I was like, I can't do this anymore. And I made a commitment to her
that I was not going to play mobile games a ton anymore. I said, every once in a while, maybe you'll see me pick up the phone and play it.
Made a commitment then. Wouldn't play those games. Wouldn't let those urges win. But there is a demon in me. It's so strong right now. Hanging and banging, brother. Don't take my phone. It's so important to me. 'Cause Catherine, you're second. All the gems of a thousand strip mines, all six stars shining from Hogan's eye, will never be enough. Never be enough. Cards of gold is still too little. Could give so much to her, but I can never pull enough. Never pull enough. Never, never, never for me. Scopely, Randy Savage, Undertaker, DX Christian, for me, for me, for me.
See?
Just a real simple yes or no. Mm-hmm. Do you currently still play WWE Champions?
Yes.
We'll see you later, everybody.
Much drama.
This one goes out to the one and only. The big cat, the fat cat, big ups.
I first saw you in Burger King. You took two seats 'cause that ass is way too big. Had a boyfriend, I realized, but you told him lies. With your raccoon eyes. The DoorDash is here. Wipe away your tears. Got you extra fries, and they taste just right. Have no fear, there's no trolls here. Kevin made you cry with those raccoon eyes. Raccoon eyes. Raccoon eyes. Kevin made you cry with those raccoon eyes. Take you power walking on the beach, feasting on some sushi like you were a queen. Let me run some errands while you sleep. I can watch you play Skyrim all day this week. Have no fear, there's no trolls here. Kevin made you cry with those raccoon eyes. Raccoon eyes. Raccoon eyes. Kevin made you cry with those raccoon eyes.
guys, every day when I wake up, that's the best day of my life. I feel like this next day is awesome. I have a beautiful wife who I love so much. She loves me and a family, Jasper, and you know, the things we get to do together. You know, I definitely want more time with them and more family time, but I absolutely love my life today compared to how it used to be. Seriously. All those years back then, you'd be like, it's a whirlwind of crap. It was me. And by the way, I've told you guys about my past. I used to drink way too much. I would be drinking constantly, all the time, because I was so stressed out. I was, honestly, when I started with this whole thing, I was depressed many years ago, you know, a decade ago. I didn't like my life or anything. And basically, liquor was the way to kind of get through that. You know, it was, oh, I hate my life. I hate who I am. So let me just drink it all away and just keep pumping out fucking YouTube videos. I don't have to do that shit anymore. You know, like, I'm happy with who I am. I actually don't think clicking like on a live stream helps at all. So it really doesn't matter if this stream gets 100 likes or 2. I don't think it affects it.
So much drama.